Misty afternoon brings us to Ray Fisher Stadium here on this Saturday afternoon in Ann Arbor, where Michigan is looking to get back on track after two disappointing losses in their own unique ways here on this Saturday afternoon against the Maryland Terrapins. Michigan coming off a heartbreaking loss where they blew a two-run lead in the ninth inning after fighting all the way back, getting down early, climbing back, and then blew an 8-6 lead in the ninth, gave up five runs at the hands of Will Rogers, the pitcher. And Michigan tried to claw back in the bottom of the ninth, but could not get it done. And today, Michigan is now looking to get back on track, get a win against a very talented and strong Maryland Terrapins team who is at the top of the Big Ten. So I'm now going to bring in my partner, Zach Edwards. My name is Joshua Brown, and we are here on the call for WCBN FM Ann Arbor. I'm going to bring in Zach and get his thoughts early on, you know, how Michigan can kind of go about responding after a very tough loss yesterday where it felt like they had a really good chance to steal an early win in the series.
Yeah, definitely would have been a very, very crucial win there for Michigan just to be able to get in. I mean, they had a great lead going into that ninth inning. They were up 8-6, I believe, and so they were in a really good spot, but unfortunately, Will Rogers just kind of let up those runs and ultimately led to what we found was an 11-9 loss. And so today, I think Michigan will again kind of have to start relying more on that hitting as they kind of have all season. Obviously, the pitching just really hasn't been there for Michigan the same way that it has in past years. And so Jacob Denner will be getting the start at the mound today for the Wolverines. And so we'll see if he can kind of keep the Maryland bats at bay, especially when it matters most getting later into the game. But yeah, as long as Michigan bats can come alive, I think they'll have a pretty good chance today as they have in past games and just getting runs on the board. The defense just got to hold them.
Absolutely. And this is a team in past years that, you know, maybe they would have last year, for example, with Connor O'Halloran, and a reliable, Friday starter, but that depth on the rest of the weekend would be limited and lacking. But this year, it just really feels like Tracy Smith and his team are really struggling to find those guys to turn to. Dylan Vigueux got roughed up early in, his start yesterday. Maryland got out to a 5-0 lead to start before Michigan clawed its way back. You know, Michigan, you really don't know what they're going to get because they can always hit. Their pitching is always inconsistent and unreliable. So today for Michigan, it'll be Jacob Denner getting his start, a veteran senior who this year has had his ups and downs as he had last year. 6.66 ERA and 1-3 on the year for Denner. Going against Logan Koster for Maryland, who's a right-handed pitcher. And we are going to see Denner first with Maryland getting up to the plate as we are a few minutes here from first pitch here on this Saturday afternoon. Little misty day. It's Bark in the Park day, so some dogs will be out. But definitely would have liked some better weather for this little festive day, but should have some very exciting baseball to come your way here. And just going to go and run through the lineup cards here for both teams momentarily. Michigan 9-17 on the year, 2-2 in the Big Ten. Did kind of have that nice series win against Penn State after dropping the Friday game. Lost a midweek game to Michigan State that didn't count for conference play before blowing yesterday's game. A.J. Garcia in replace of Jonathan Kim, who's still kind of battling a finger or hand type injury that occurred in a midweek game a couple weeks ago against Toledo. And then A.J. Garcia will be taking a spot. The freshman is batting .421 on year and will be leading off today for the Wolverines. Mitch Voigt, the always reliable hitter, loves to slot into that two spot before Steven Hirosh, who has really kind of come into his own and really picked up the pace throughout the year, been very solid, and has played a very big role on Michigan's offense, heating up. Was batting in the low twos, but has really brought his average up in recent weeks and started Big Ten play. Designated hitter today will be Colin Priest, who had a walk-off home run a couple weeks ago against San Diego and has been very good for Michigan. Priest has been a very solid piece on that team. And then looking at the five spot will be Dylan Stanton at first base, Cole Caruso at third, Will Rogers behind the plate at catcher, Mac Timbrook at second, and Kyle Drinetti at third. For Maryland, it will be Braden Martin batting leadoff, the right fielder, the shortstop Kevin Keister at short batting second, Eddie Hakopian at first base, Sam Hosnar at second, on the cleanup spot, Jacob Orr batting fifth in the third spot, Alex Clarko at the designated hitter spot, batting sixth, Luke Zeisloft in left field, batting seventh, Devin Russell, the catcher behind the plate at eight, and then the ninth spot will be Elijah Lambros at center field.
So Eddie Hakopian today is coming in with Maryland's best average at .376, and so he'll be in at that three spot. Hopefully Maryland will be able to get one of their first two batters on base, that potentially Hakopian can come and drive those in with his top average on the team. However, batting just after him is Sam Hojnar, who has the best on-base percentage for the Terrapins. And so as long as Maryland's able to get those first two people on base throughout the lineup and getting those other players in with those 3-4 cleanup spots, it should be a good day for the Maryland offense. But Jacob Denner, again, warming up right now as we're getting ready for him to get his start. Ultimately, on the season, he's 1-3 with 9 appearances, and so we'll see if in his 10th appearance here he's able to get the win.
Yeah, and you mentioned Eddie Hakopian. He had the go-ahead 2-RBI single in the 9th to give Maryland a 9-8 lead that they would never relinquish. And Sam Hojnar at second base had 3 critical RBIs to help give Maryland kind of lead early and then ultimately to sort of pad their lead late in the 9th. As the Michigan infield and team is warming up, getting ready to kick this off, Braden Martin will be batting leadoff for the Terps, who's now brought his average up to .299 on the year. He's been very, very solid and consistent. Started all 63 games, or never mind, he's a freshman, not started, that was Copian, but he's a freshman, had his first collegiate hit against Georgia Southern, and has 2 3-RBI games in the year, 20 hits, or now more than that on the year. As Denner gets ready to look for the first pitch of the game to Martin. Here's the first pitch of the game, and that is in there for strike one. It's going to be very important for Denner to settle in here early, find his footing. He has the potential, but, you know, can be a little erratic at times. The 0-1 pitch from Denner comes in, fouled off behind the stands.
And Braden Martin coming in today with a .299 average, sitting just below that .300, has a .433 on-base percentage, and able to get on base, both with walks as well as hits. So seeing if he can get this batting started here for the Terrapins.
Yeah, Martin was 3-for-5 on the day yesterday as the 0-2 comes in, and it hits Braden Martin. A bad pitch there by Denner on an 0-2 count. Goes inside on the lefty-lefty pitching matchup. And yeah. Martin is now on first base.
Unlucky
there
for Denner.
Unforced error there, especially on a very favorable pitcher's count.
Yeah. Now, unable to capitalize on that 0-2 count, as you said, Josh. Definitely unlucky there, as Denner really had him right where he wanted him. But
Kevin Keister now up to the plate for Maryland, who was the first team All-Big Ten in 2022. Started and played in all 63 games last year and is now a senior on the team. As the ball is hit by Keister into right field, as Martin looks to take third, and he will stop at second. A base hit already for Maryland as they are looking to pour it on early in this game with now a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, and Braden Martin looked like he almost wanted to get, he started around second, not quite made it all the way to third, and decided to backtrack into second, but nonetheless, runner in scoring position, as you mentioned, as now runners on first and second in the top of the first here.
Yeah, Mitch Voigt out in right field was looking to potentially gun down Braden Martin, as now steps up to the plate to Sakopian, who had that go-ahead 2-RBI hit yesterday, as the first pitch is fired in, and that is low for ball one. So Denner, after what looked like two promising pitches, gets the hit by pitch and then a base hit in back-to-back pitches. And now, all of a sudden, you have traffic on the base pass. The 1-0 pitch from Denner as he looks to the runner on second. It's fired in and that is fouled off, heading towards the cars. Smacks down on the concrete parking lot here outside Ray Fisher Stadium. Copian, as you know, I mentioned, had that 2-RBI game yesterday. As Denner looks at Martin, the 1-1 comes in and he's showing bunt, and that'll get down as the third place play is made and he is out. A nice play made by Cole Caruso to throw it to Dylan Stanton and get the runner out at first, but the bunt did sacrifice and advance the runners into scoring position, as now Martin and Keister are on third and second respectively.
Yeah, so that was a great hit there by Hakopian just to get the batters advance, still only one out here in this first inning, so might be able to make a little bit of leeway as runners are now two runners in scoring position at second and third respectively.
A base hit here would have a very good chance of scoring two runs, is now up to the plate as Sam Hojnar, one of the stars of yesterday's game, the left-handed hitter, a lefty-lefty matchup. Let's see what Denner can do here. Here's the first pitch of the at-bat, and that is just outside for ball one.
Hojnar comes in as definitely one of Maryland's top power hitters with 5 home runs. It leads the team, as well as 25 RBIs, which is tied for lead on this team. So definitely looking to get these two runners in here at the top of the first.
Batting .264 on the year and has started in all 26 games for the Terps. A And that second pitch is fouled off, and the count evens at 1-1. Yeah, Hosnar leads the team in at-bats with 110, 29 hits out of those 110 to give him that batting average with 25 RBIs tied for the team lead. The 1-1 coming in from Denner to Hosnar is swing and a miss. A 1-2 count provides Denner with a very solid opportunity here to get the second out of the inning.
Yeah, Denner's right where he wants him. Again, that 1-2 count could potentially strike out without any damage being done.
Obviously, the opportunity for a sacrifice fly as well as the 1-2 comes in from Denner, and that is inside. Kind of got close to the hands of Hosnar there, but snagged there by Will Rogers. No hit by pitch, but the count is now 2-2.
Hosnar still the only player on this Maryland team to be perfect on steal attempts, so if he is able to get on base, could potentially be a steal there.
4-5-6 on base percentage as well as the 2-2 comes from Denner, and that is popped up. Foul as Cole Caruso comes to make the play in foul territory, and he makes the catch for the second out of the inning. And now Michigan is one out away from getting out of a massive jam early in this game. Maryland pounced on the Wolverines early, so Michigan's trying to avoid that same fate that they had yesterday, even though they were able to come back. Those runs ultimately mattered as Michigan blew the lead in the ninth. Now coming up to the plate for Maryland is Jacob Orr, batting 325 in the year, starting 20 out of the Terps, 26 games. That he's played in the third baseman, batting 325 on the year. As the first pitch comes from Denner, and that is in there for a strike. A little low, but did get the call there.
Jacob Orr, also one of these Maryland players that's able to get on base quite often, a 475 on-base percentage.
As low strikeout guy as well, only 9 Ks on the year. A tough guy to strike out, short on his stature. There's a swing and a miss there, and now Orr is in danger of his 10th strikeout on the season, facing an 0-2 count from Jacob Denner, as he is now one pitch away from getting out of a massive jam and gaining some early momentum here for Michigan. Denner looks, sets, fires on the 0-2, and that is high for ball one.
Yeah, Jacob Denner done a great job so far this first inning, getting pitchers in the count, or batters in the count that he would like them. As now 1-2 here to Orr, and had similar counts in the prior two at-bats.
Martin looks to take a lead off third as Denner throws in the 1-2, and a swing and a miss. Jacob Orr goes down swinging as Jacob Denner gets out of the first inning jam for Michigan. As Michigan now heads into the bottom of the first, still tied 1-1. If you were to tell me with runners on first and second and Jacob Denner looking a little erratic, the hit by pitch of Braden Martin and Kevin Keister's nice base hit into the right side to Mitch Foy in right field, I would have been stunned if he said he didn't score. Yeah. Maryland tried up with that small ball at the three spot with Eddie Hacopian to advance the runners, get some runs early, but it didn't work as Hosnar fouled out and then Jacob Orr struck out swinging for Denner's first K of the afternoon.
Yeah, not to mention those runners at first and second, both were there with no out, so really, really dangerous position there for Michigan. But able to get that first out, and then the second one is that fly out kind of over on the third base line, and that really set up a great position there for Denner just to end the inning on a strikeout. So even though Jacob Orr came in with one of the best on-base percentages, and as you mentioned, only 9 strikeouts on the season, Jacob Denner able to finish him off and end the inning unscathed for the Wolverines. And again, Michigan in a good position here to set up their offense to get going, as Garcia, Voit, and Rustich will be the first three up for the Wolverines at the top of the order. And all three have very solid, not only averages, but on-base percentages. And A.J. Garcia, again, like you said, coming in kind of after Jacob Kim had that injury. So excited here to see the top of the order here.
Yeah. And A.J. Garcia in replace of Jonathan Kim, 1-5 yesterday. So did struggle a little bit and brought his batting average down after a hot start to his freshman campaign. Will Rogers was the one Wolverine that did go yard yesterday with a 3-run shot to tie the game at 5. A lot of doubles yesterday for Michigan, coming from Garcia, Voit, Priest, Stanton, Caruso, and Timbrook. Caruso had 3 hits for Michigan, and so did Mac Timbrook. They both went 3-for-5 on the day, and Mitch Voit went 2-for-4, drew a walk in there. Steven Hrush is that main power bat, the only player in Michigan's current lineup that has more than 3 home runs on the season. Hrush leads the team with 8 and 20 RBIs total. Caruso does have 19 RBIs, doesn't have that, you know, insane kind of power that Hrush has, but is able to make contributions by finding ways to get on base. And now A.J. Garcia, the left-handed hitter, will step up to the plate against Logan Koster, who has a 2.72 ERA with a 4-1 record in his 6 starts on the season and 36.1 innings pitched. The right-handed pitcher looks to Garcia and fires inside here. A little bit of a favorable matchup with the righty-lefty, so Garcia will have that advantage. Those pitches will naturally drag a little bit more inside into the sweet spot here for Garcia. So Michigan starting off with the lefty against Koster as the second pitch of the at-bat is fouled off out of the park. The count is now 1-1 for Garcia.
As you mentioned, Logan Koster 4-1 on the year, so really one of the strongest pitchers for the Terrapins with a 2.72 ERA.
The 1-1 pitch from Koster is popped up towards foul territory, and that is just foul, not going to drop over the head of the third baseman, not too far from the Michigan bullpen, but does plop in foul.
Yeah, AJ
sort of was hooking.
He put that in almost the perfect spot. It was right between the left fielder as well as the shortstop and third baseman, but just barely went foul. If that would have gone in, would have been a very, very easy base hit.
Yeah, easy base hit. Yep. Maybe could have potentially taken second. It would have been hard to tell. Garcia out of Chicago, Illinois, as that pitch is fired right to the first baseman, hit by Garcia, and that'll be out number one.
Yeah, Eddie Hacopian does a good job there just to set his feet, pick up the ball, and walk his way over to first for a pretty routine out there as A.J. Garcia, the first Wolverine batter, is retired.
Yeah, it was kind of ripped down the line, but right to Hacopian. Easy fielding play, was able to get to first with plenty of time. And now up comes the star bat, the star player of this Michigan baseball team, Mitch Voit, batting in that number two spot to hopefully get on base to set up the power guy, Hrusich, at third. The Northwestern transfer, Hrusich, as the first pick comes into Voit. And that is in there for a strike, strike one. Now Koster goes ahead on the count, 0-1. The lefty-lefty matchup here with Voit will help Koster out a little bit. Here's the second pitch of that bat, and that is fouled up. Looks like it's heading towards the bullpen and that tracks into the Maryland bullpen. Martin looked like he was trying to maybe make a play, but he had no chance of getting that. Plops right into the Maryland bullpen there.
Yeah, well, Voit is definitely one of Michigan's, if not their absolute strongest hitter. He does lead the team in strikeouts with 26, so getting down in the count like this 0-2 could prove pretty fatal for him here, especially with such a strong arm coming from the Terrapins.
Yeah, not someone who's keen on drawing walks with his on-base percentage. Not that much higher than his batting average here, as the third pitch they bat is just outside. So Voit does get a little bit of call here. Good frame attempt there by Maryland catcher Devin Russell, but does not get the call from the umpire. The 1-2 coming in from Koster, and that is grounded to Kevin Keister at shortstop to Hacopian to get out number two.
Great play there by the Maryland infield, just able to fling it right over from shortstop to first base, and a lot of those pitches that actually went to Mitch Voit were kind of on that right side of the strike zone. Didn't bite on those first and third pitches, ultimately fouled that second, but that last pitch was kind of right in the middle of the zone, so thought maybe he'd have a base hit there, but pretty routine play for Maryland.
Yeah, Koster's not really a strikeout guy in this 36.1 innings pitch entering the game as Hrusich swings for strike number one. Only 19 strikeouts in 36.1 innings pitch. That'll now be 37 innings pitch with those first two outs of the day. So just 19 strikeouts in 37 innings is not that much as the 0-1 comes fired in. That'll be just a little bit high for Hrusich, and the count is now 1-1.
And Josh, you mentioned before, Hrusich is definitely Michigan's power hitter with 8 home runs and 20 RBIs, leads the team by 5 in home runs. So while no one on base to bring him in, could potentially open up the scoring.
Here's the 1-1 to Hrusich, and that is outside for ball number 2. No shift here at all really in play here for Maryland. Both, you know, kind of middle infielders playing a little on the deeper side. Middle is a little bit open. Shortstop Keister's playing a little bit towards the left side as the 1-2 is popped up in the air. Hosnar and Martin are going to communicate, and Martin in right field will make the catch and get out number 3. A 1-2-3 inning for Logan Koster, and Michigan goes down. No strikeouts, as Koster's really not a strikeout guy as we were talking about, but a disappointing inning there for Michigan just to not get any really traffic on the bases, but you have to hope that contact will come.
Yeah, and really good job there for Michigan, just making contact, kind of starting to set the tone a little bit, trying to get into a little bit of a rhythm. Ultimately, all of them were pretty much either a ground out or, again, that last one was that fly out. So Michigan hoping that contact leads to a little bit more of a payoff on the on the base running, on the scoring, but ultimately we'll end the inning. It'll be 0-0 between Maryland and Michigan here.
Yeah, scoreless game heading into the top of the second. Xander looks to kind of settle in as he faces Alex Kolarko, the designated hitter. He's batting .221 on the year before facing Luke Zeisloff, the left fielder, who does not have a hit on the year. Only one start on the year and seven games played, but just four at-bats on the year. So very small sample size there, Luke Zeisloff. Out in left field, will be due up second in this inning. Devin Russell, the catcher, batting .181 on the season, a sophomore. He's the catcher on this team. And then Elijah Lambros, batting .293, so kind of that bridge guy back to the top of the order if Maryland gets a runner on base. Lambros is likely to come up, barring any double play or anything. So right out of the gate to start this inning, seems like Denner opportunities beckon for him to potentially get an out or two early on while facing the bottom of this Maryland lineup.
Yeah, and in that first inning, he kind of struggled there with the top of the order, as pretty much all of them were able to get on base. But once he got more into the meat of that Maryland lineup, he's able to shut him out, ultimately get the last strikeout of the inning, which was very, very crucial, and keep Maryland off the board with two runners in scoring position. But headed towards the bottom of the Maryland lineup, and hopefully Denner will be able to get around and find himself unscathed.
The top of the second is now here as Denner now faces Alex Kolarko. Kolarko, a right-handed hitter, and the first pitch is fouled off.
Yeah, Kolarko with one of the lowest averages here out of the starters, .221 on the season, and 86 at-bats.
Yeah,
only
not
19
kind of the
hits.
Production that you'd hope out of, you know, a designated hitter spot, but still solid and, you know, has the opportunity to bring that up. The 0-1 pitch is a swing and a miss there by Alex Kolarko.
And Kolarko is going to have one of the largest strike boxes of anyone here today, standing at 6'5", one of the tallest players of either team.
Kolarko, a Northwestern transfer, was on the same team as Steven Hrustic last season. So facing his former teammate, now both players in different Big Ten uniforms facing each other now. That pitch was high for ball number one. The 1-2 pitch from Jacob Denner comes in, and a swing and a miss. Alex Kolarko goes down swinging for Denner's second straight forwards K, as out number one of the inning is recorded.
Yeah, great job from Denner these last two at-bats. Like you just said, both were strikeouts, both starting to get into a little bit of a groove here, and he's really going to need to get this momentum going just so that he can keep Maryland off the board, especially as Michigan looks to try and get on the board towards the bottom of this inning.
A lot of cheers out for Luke Zeisloff from Bloomsburg, Pennsylvania, middle of the state, as a ball hit by Zeisloff is grounded right to Dylan Stan at first, and he steps on the bag to make the play.
Yeah, again, that's a very similar play to what we saw at the beginning of last inning, as for the Terrapins, it was Eddie Okopian who was able to make that pretty routine play at first. Same there from Dylan Stanton, just able to pick it up and walk right to the bag and get the second out of the inning for the Terrapins.
Up now to the plate is Devin Russell, the catcher. And Denner is now looking for a 1-2-3 inning here as the first pitch is fired in there for
a ball. It's a little bit high on that one, but Devin Russell coming in with .181 batting average on the season with 72 at-bats.
That second pitch is fouled way over the press box here at Ray Fisher Stadium for a foul. Denner done a good job so far of keeping his pitch count down, hoping to potentially go for a longer start. 100 pitches is, especially now in this current age of baseball and preserving arms, is kind of that average time. If you have a quality start, that's where you'll often be sent out. As the third pitch of the at-bat, very beautiful pitch by Denner and slides in there for strike number two. And Denner now one pitch away from a 1-2-3 inning here. An opportunity to get his third strikeout of the game right here, right now, as the 1-2 to Russell is a swing and a miss. Jacob Denner, with two strikeouts in the inning, gets the strikeout of Devin Russell as Maryland goes scoreless once again for the second straight inning.
That's a beautiful pitch from Denner. Nice little slider that caught kind of the outside of the zone, but it seemed like Russell really liked that pitch and swung on and ends up with Denner getting his third strikeout.
Yeah, Denner kind of got him to chase a little bit there, as nice little off-speed there ultimately fooled Devin Russell. And now heading into the Michigan at-bat side of things, Colin Priest will be leading off this inning. Has a lot of that homer, had that walk-off home run, as I mentioned earlier in the broadcast. followed by Dylan Sin and Cole Caruso. So similar lineup that Michigan's using from yesterday, trying to manage things with the absence of Jonathan Kim. Kind of going over some of the performances from yesterday. Priest was 1 of 3. Stanton was 2 for 5 with a run scored and an RBI as well. But Caruso had 2 RBIs, 3 for 5 on the day, and did score a run himself. So Caruso, if they can get a runner on the base for him, he's not that power home run guy. But if you get, you know, a leadoff double or a runner in scoring position, he's the guy that you want to bring him home.
Yeah, absolutely. This part of the lineup did, again, like you mentioned, a pretty good job yesterday of not only getting RBIs, but getting on base and getting kind of the motion going on throughout the infield. But we'll see what Colin Priest can do here at the bottom of the second. Still 0-0 here from Ann Arbor.
And Priest is excellent at drawing walks. So, you know, with just a .262 batting average, but a .456 on base percentage, that walk percentage is very high. For Colin Priest, almost, you know, a 20% walk percentage. So, you know, opportunity here facing a lefty-lefty matchup as Priest, the left-handed hitter, steps up to the plate to face Logan Koster, an early opportunity to get on base. Here's the first pitch from Koster, and that is low for ball one.
Colin Priest is the freshman from Florida looking to get the Wolverines started here.
Second pitch there is low for ball two. 2-0 count, hitter's count. Talked about Priest and his ability to draw walks. Well, a perfect opportunity for him to draw yet another one is right here, right now. The 2-0 pitch from Koster is grounded foul. I think that one probably would have gone low for ball three there.
Yeah, seemed like Priest was getting a little bit too comfortable on that one and looking to get a little bit get going here as Wolverine Sylvan had a hit so far in this game. But 2-1 nonetheless, still leaning at hitter's count.
2-1 to Priest, and that is hit down deep into left field. And that is clearing the left field wall for a home run for Colin Priest. A beautiful swing of the bat, and Priest will trot around the bases for a solo shot of Michigan's first run of the day.
Yeah, very exciting there from Colin Priest. His fourth home run of the season. Now firmly in second for the Wolverines. But yeah, getting his, again, his 11th RBI in the season, that fourth home run, opened up the scoring here in Ann Arbor.
His fourth home run of the year. A beautiful swing of the bat by Colin Priest on a ball that just kept carrying, and ultimately Luke Zeisloft in left field just had to turn and watch it sail over the wall and left center. A great swing of the bat there by Colin Priest. And now Dylan Sand looks to try to make it back-to-back home runs if he can, but also just try to get on base and keep that momentum going for Cole Caruso, who's on deck. And a nice base hit there from Dylan Stanton as he will trot to first base. Got past Jacob Orr at third, and Stanton will take first base.
Yeah, very hard hit there from Stanton as it Jacob Orr tries to make a dive kind of right next to him to get that stop, but ultimately goes all the way out in the outfield.
And now Cole Caruso will step up to the bat, trying to build off of his successful day yesterday. His average is up to .202, and now Logan Koster is starting to deal with some trouble. Michigan with a 1-0 lead and a runner on first. Not the position you want to be in here, but Koster's going to have to settle down quick as Caruso's up and the first pitch is out wide for ball one.
And Josh, you mentioned Cole Caruso is one of these players that maybe won't hit a home run, but with a runner on base at first could potentially advance these runners with no outs.
Yeah, and Will Rogers on deck for Michigan hit a home run yesterday. So if he can get on base here, that would be big. As a steal attempt by second, will be safe. A nice stolen base there from Dylan Stanton as he took second base. The throw from Devin Russell was not in time as Sam Hosnar came, tried to field it, but the throw was just way too late. A nice stolen base there, got a nice jump there.
And Cole Caruso swung on that pitch too. It seemed to be really low and outside, but he had a kind of a lag swing there. But
in some ways, maybe that swing, you know, delays a little bit of that stolen base. So yeah, now you have a runner on scoring position for someone who's known to get those kind of base knocks. So opportunity beckons for Cole Caruso here as the 1-1 gets ready to get fired in from Keister. And that ball is punched out into right field for a base hit. That is off the wall, off the bounce. And Dylan Samuel scores. Cole Caruso with a stand-up double. And Michigan extends its lead to 2-0.
And look
excellent
at that.
Excellent hit there from Cole Caruso.
Still no outs on the inning as Michigan really able to start this hitting going. Went 1-2-3 last inning, but still every single batter so far this inning has been able to get the ball on the wood and get it going. So now reaching towards the bottom of the lineup, Will Rogers coming up to bat for Michigan. Cole Caruso had a great hit to bring in Dylan Stanton. Now 2-0 for the Wolverines, exactly where they want to be.
Yeah, up to bat now. Will Rogers with himself with a runner on scoring position. Here's the pitch from Coster. Looking rattled. And that ball is inside. Not too far from hitting Will Rogers there as the count is now 1-0.
And Will Rogers this year sitting at 211 on the season in 71 at-bats. So not one of the top highest averages, but has three home runs, including one yesterday.
Second pitch there is low for ball two.
And so Will Rogers here, all the way, already up in the count 2-0, is looking to potentially get on base. With
yeah.
No out still.
Coster struggling to find the strike zone here as the 2-0 pitch comes in. And that is low. A very friendly hitter's count now at 3-0. Mac Timbrook is on deck for Michigan. Timbrook went 3-for-5 yesterday with two runs scored himself and an RBI. So an opportunity potentially with another hot hitter for Michigan, you know, on deck. Coster yearning to find the strike zone here as he looks at staying on second. And here's the 3-0 pitch, and that is high for ball four. First and second with no outs and two runs already in. The dream start here to the inning for Michigan.
So Logan Coster starting to fall a little bit out of his groove is now. That's four straight batters that have either touched a bag or gone all the way around because of that first home run. And so now with runners on first and second, Mac Timbrook looking to hopefully send some more Wolverine runners in as they already have two here in the bottom of the inning.
Yeah, it's Maryland now bringing the infield in for a mound visit here. Coster looking rattled. No sign of life right now in the Terrapins bullpen. No one warming up yet. We'll see if Maryland does make a call to the bullpen anytime soon. And based on that, you know, maybe they're looking to potentially pull Coster. Nothing yet. They got to trust their guy with a 2.72 ERA. Really struggling with his command and finding the strike zone. A four-pitch walk, very uncharacteristic. He's not a strikeout guy, and you know, sometimes when you struggle to get strikeouts, you know, ultimately you can't have those days where they find solid contact, they find ways through the infield, and that's almost exactly what's happening today. A couple of really nice base hits, had that nice double by Cole Caruso. But when you don't get a lot of strikeouts, you give opportunities for balls to be put in play and find gaps.
Yeah, and Logan Coster is one of these pitchers that normally stays in the game for quite a while. Has six games and six starts with 36 innings. So
yeah, so coming into the game, averaging six innings a start.
Yep.
So, I mean, this would be very uncharacteristic. Still only three outs recorded here for Coster as his ERA is over three now at 3.13 with no more outs recorded in this inning so far. And now Mac Timbrook accepted to the plate a righty-lefty matchup. This will favor Timbrook here. It's a pickoff attempt from second base. It's definitely not going to be there in time as Stanton stands on second base right now. Got Stanton on second, Will Rogers on first. And after the pickoff attempt, Coster will look at Devin Russell, the catcher, and fire a pitch in, and that'll be a bunt foul. So Michigan's strategy in hand being shown here as they are going to try to look to potentially advance these runners.
Yeah, that bunt was almost exactly where they wanted it. Just went foul just a little bit. If it would have stayed a little more fair, both the runners at first and second were already there pretty much.
Yeah, and now both corner defenders on first and third are playing a little bit further in with the very realistic possibility of now a bunt here on this 0-1 pitch. And a bunt laid down there nicely by Timbrook. The out at first will be recorded, but he does his job sacrificing and advancing the runners to second and third. And now Michigan with two more outs to work with. Durnetti at the nine spot and Garcia at the one with a chance to, you know, really kind of break this game open if Michigan can get knock a base hit here.
Yeah, just like you said, Josh, Mac Timbrook just doing his job, getting those runners advanced to second and third, especially with one out now. Michigan's still in great position to bring some more runners in as they have momentum going in all the way to the bottom of their lineup with Kyle Durnetti.
Giannetti coming into the game with a 245 batting average starting in all 26 games of the season, the 9-spot hitter. That first pitch is low for ball one.
Again, like you said, Giannetti coming in, 245 average, starting every game here for the Wolverines at 94 at-bats, looking to get the scoring going.
The infield is in for Giannetti here, looking to try to save a run here if the ball is in to potentially force out, you know, get a tag out at home. As that pitch, the second pitch of the at-bat, goes high and wide for ball two. Another very friendly hitter's count as Koster's just really struggling to find the strike zone here. Only out was recorded on a sacrifice bunt. And that pitch finally finds the strike zone for a strike for Koster. A little low, but did get the call there.
Logan Koster, only one walk that we saw a little bit earlier this inning so far in this game today.
The 2-1 pitch here is low, looked like a little low, and it'll be a 3-1 count. One pitch away now from loading the bases here.
This would be that second walk for Koster.
Order.
Yep.
Would provide force outs at multiple bases and could give a double play opportunity, but not the result you'd be looking for to walk slow the bases here. As the 3-1 comes in, and that's way outside. 4-4, and Michigan has the bases juice for A.G. Garcia coming up back to the top of the order. Man, this would be some kind of welcome to college baseball moment for Garcia with no home runs in the year, just two RBIs. This would be some, you know, first initial moment here for A.J. Garcia. If he can get a home run here, that would be absolutely incredible.
No home runs on the season, but this would be a great chance to get that first home run.
Absolutely. A rattled pitcher as the first pitch does go in there for a strike. Garcia going to try to work his way into the at-bat. And Garcia was one of that first three batters for Michigan that struggled. Remember, Koster had a 1-2-3 first inning. It's absolutely changed the sentence. That ball is roped from Garcia into right field, and that might clear the bases as he's heading to second, and two runners head home. A stand-up double for A.J. Garcia. An excellent hit. Kyle Giannetti still on third, but two runners come home as A.J. Garcia adds on to Michigan's lead and is now a 4-0 ball game.
That was a great hit there from A.J. Garcia, and Kyle Giannetti was really weighing his pros and cons of going all the way home there, but ultimately holds off. So it'll be just two runs for the Wolverines, but now still have runners in scoring position as Michigan's top batter, Mitch Voigt, comes up to bat.
Now Maryland finally looking to the bullpen as Andrew Johnson is starting to get warm here for the Terps. As now Mitch Voigt comes up to the plate with two runners in scoring position himself. So now Maryland exploring its options with one runner with only one out. Four runs in and two runners still left in scoring position. A base knock here can make this a 6-0 ball game here from Mitch Voigt as the 1-0 is grounded line into center field, and that'll score two runs. A 6-0 lead for Michigan as Mitch Voigt gets a base hit knock in the center field, Elijah Lamrose Field, and it is now a 6-0 ball game for the Wolverines.
And just a single there as it drives right in between, kind of towards that second base, goes all the way out into center field. Mitch Voigt with a perfect hit just to be able to bring in those runners from second and third. Now Michigan leading 6-0 in the bottom of the second after going 1-2-3 in the first. This is exactly what they were looking for from their bats heading into this inning.
Koster getting absolutely roughed up. His ERA is now over 4. Came in with the ERA sub-3 as now steps up to the plate Steven Hrustic. First pitch is high for ball one. Hrustic is that power guy, so if he can get a hold of one and take it yard, I mean, you're looking at, you know, a game where Maryland might just, you know, be looking to, you know, explore its options and maybe save some of those pitchers for tomorrow. 6-0 ball game. With Michigan's pitching, you never know. And, you know, it's very conceivable that Maryland could claw its way back in with how inconsistent Michigan's pitching's been. So that second pitch was low and the count's now 2-0. But this is very concerning for Maryland. It provides Michigan that cushion if its pitching falls by the wayside. The 2-0 pitch coming in from Koster, and that is roped into center field over the head of Elijah Lambros towards the batter's eye, and that is off the batter's eye for a home run. Steven Hrustic makes this an 8-0 ball game as Michigan takes an 8-0 lead in the second inning. Koster is getting absolutely rocked in this inning as Hrustic rounds the bases and is about to step on home, and this game is officially blown open.
I mean, this is a complete tale of two innings. Last inning went 1-2-3 in the top of the order. And now already Michigan has gone through its entire order as Cole Priest, who's the one who started this inning, is now up to bat for the Wolverines. And it is an 8-0 ball game.
Looks
as every
like
single batter to
Logan
this point
Koster
has gone in.
Koster is finally going to get the boot here. Absolute smash hit there from Steven Hrustic. Landed right between the batter's eye and the center field wall, but just absolutely crushed out to dead center.
And Logan Koster, like you said, came in with that 272 average, is now coming out of the game with a 454 average. So almost double of what he started is what he's going to end with today. And just an unlucky day for him, as, again, that first inning was just so strong, able to get all three batters out, 1-2-3. And now, I mean, this inning is just completely, a completely different story. Mm-hmm.
They're playing bad day here at Ray Fisher Stadium, and that would honestly be an understatement with how Logan Koster got roughed up today. What a disastrous start. Looked like a very promising first inning and absolutely snowballed after that leadoff home run from Colin Priest.
Yeah, and yesterday, Maryland got off to a 5-0 lead after the third inning, but, I mean, this is three more runs than it was yesterday. Michigan, again, was able to claw its way back a little bit yesterday, getting that ultimate 8-6 lead going into the ninth inning. But, I mean, that's a completely different story from an 8-0 lead already just in the second inning, bottom of the second. And, again, we're going into that meat of the Michigan lineup with Cole Priest up to bat, and there's still only one out for the Wolverines. So still a lot of room to operate and get even more runs to what has been a very, very strong inning for Michigan here.
Absolutely. Now, on deck for Michigan will be Colin Priest. So Michigan is fully battered around and still has two outs to work with. So there's only one out recorded in the inning. Colin Priest began this inning with a leadoff home run out to left center field, and now will be facing, I believe this will be number five for the Terrapins, Andrew Johnson, who's warming up. He's coming in a spot where it's not even just damage control, but, you know, trying to limit the deficit of this game is, you know, listen, Maryland can score a lot of runs. They scored nine on Michigan in nine innings, so as much as a safe lead as this is, I mean, all it takes is, you know, one bad pitcher for Michigan, and this game is, you know, very alive all of a sudden.
And absolutely. Andrew Johnson coming into this game with only seven innings pitched, but five strikeouts, two walks, and two hits. So sitting at a zero ERA.
Yes. Solid pitch on the year, but limited sample size here as he's a left-handed pitcher facing a left-handed hitter here. And Colin Priest, the first pitch, it catches the corner of the plate, the outside corner, four strike one.
Andrew Johnson starting off strong here for the Terrapins. Already starting to get more into a pitcher's count, 0-1. And we saw very little of that from Logan Koster early in the inning.
Now starting to get into those pitcher's counts here, but that pitch was outside there for ball one.
Again, Colin Priest up to bat, already gone through all of Michigan's order so far in this bottom of the second inning. So he looks at the 1-1 pitch.
Here's the 1-1, and does he go? He holds off. It looks like Priest kind of checked his swing there. The count is now 2-1.
That ball was very far outside, so smart decision there from Colin Priest to hold off on that one.
A 2-1 pitcher from Johnson. That is low for 3-1. Maryland pitchers just can't seem to find the strike zone right now, Zach.
Yeah, it seems like, again, when Logan Koster was in, he barely found that strike zone. And when he did, Michigan just absolutely crushed that ball nearly every time. So even now with a new pitcher, struggling to find that strike zone is 3-1 is the count to Colin Priest.
Michigan has a team batting 6-for-9 in the day with two walks. Very nice. As that ball is roped, nice diving catch there from Eddie Halopian. Diving play to rob Colin Priest of another base hit.
Yeah, Kopian now has two of the Terrapins, five outs going right to him. Again, we saw that one in the first inning, kind of dribble right over to him, and then he stepped over. That one made a very nice diving catch.
Excellent play at first base there by Hakopian.
Yeah, much needed out there. Potentially could turn the tides here this second inning, and Maryland can come out after eight runs already scored.
Maryland just struggling to find out number three here. Finally gets out number two, though, and now looking to just end this inning once and for all and just try to flush it down the toilet and respond at the plate in the top of the third with the top with their top of the order coming up. They will have 9-1-2 heading in the top of the order. That pitch is inside there as the count's now 1-1 to Dylan Stanton.
Dylan Stanton had that single back all the way at the beginning of the inning. Now looking to keep his hitting up with the 1-1 count.
Stanton with a 3.86 slugging percentage as the pitch is a swing and a miss there from Dylan Stanton. Inside pitch with a little bit of off-speed there, kind of fooled Stanton.
Yeah, great off-speed pitch there, as you said, from Andrew Johnson. Already now in a pitcher's count, 1-2. And two outs looking to end this inning after a multitude of runs.
Johnson trying to settle in here and get out number three as the 1-2 pitch is roped down the left field line. And that'll be fair off the wall as Stanton will look to take second base on a stand-up double. Dylan Stanton, a double roped off the left field wall. A line drive hit, and now another runner in scoring position for Michigan with Cole Caruso up to bat. We were talking about him as that base hit guy earlier at a stand-up double. Being another one of those, it'll be a 9-0 ball game.
Yeah, and as you said, Caruso got that double, had one RBI all the way back at the beginning of the inning. Now Stanton, 2-for-2 on the day. Caruso looking to follow suit again after that double. And another double here. But send Stanton home and add Michigan's 9th run of the inning.
An 8-0 lead for Michigan with a runner on second as Caruso takes ball one. Stanton trying to take a big lead off second to get in that position. If Caruso can knock one through the infield to be able to score and make this a 9-0 ball game. Base running is such an underrated element of baseball. Watching Pittsburgh Pirates, their homeowner, just a lot of key, you know, base running errors that nearly cost them their opener. As that pitch there, strike one. It's always sometimes that fine line of, you know, if they are to get a base hit, you know, do you give them the stop sign or let them go here? So depending on where this ball is hit, will Stan have a chance at scoring? As the 1-1 pitch is inside there, as the count is now 2-1.
So now, Andrew Johnson done a pretty good job of getting the counts he wants. Starting to fall a little bit behind here, 2-1. Again, two outs here in the bottom of the second.
2-1 pitch is ready to come in there from Johnson. That is inside, nearly hits Cole Caruso, but he avoids it and is now a 3-1 hitter's count.
Yeah, Caruso in a good spot here just to get a walk, get on base. And that would be his 11th walk of the season, if he's able to get it here. Umpire will take a second, walks around a little bit, but now back ready to go is Andrew
Johnson. He's starting to get a little restless after this eight-run inning for Michigan.
Absolutely.
3-1 count now coming in from Johnson. And that'll be strike two as Caruso tosses bat, thinking he would be taking his base. Looked a little low, but the call is made for strike number two.
Yeah, Josh, like you said, a little low, but, I mean, Caruso definitely thought that wasn't a strike, but the umpire says
part
otherwise.
Part of that was a little bit of acting as well, trying to sell the call. A full count pitch here, the payoff pitch here coming in from Johnson. The pitch is thrown, and that will be ball four. Just a little bit. It looked like low and outside there.
Yeah, it looked
Caruso
like
Caruso with first and second now. Michigan has batted around and then some. Will Rogers, who was due up fourth to start the inning, is now getting his second at-bat of the inning. Speaks to just how Michigan has really piled on in this game.
Yes, no. Caruso sitting at 1-1 on the day, and then just before him was Dylan Stanton, 2-2 on the day, as Will Rogers comes up 1-for-1 on the day, looking again to follow suit of his prior batters.
First pitch is outside, but does get the call for strike one. Nice pitch there from Johnson, Andrew Johnson.
And Barton Rogers, beginning of the inning, had a walk, so still standing at 0-for-0 on the day. But three home runs, 12 RBIs, looking to keep the scoring going here.
That pitch is low from Johnson. Now it is a 1-1 count here.
Seems like Devin Russell, the Maryland catcher, is kind of had to walk around and get a lot of these lower pitches that have kind of rubbed along in the dirt towards home plate. Xander Johnson is sending a lot of them a little bit low.
Rogers drew a walk at his first at bat. A 1-1 pitch here from Andrew Johnson comes in, and that's outside for a 2-1 count.
So Rogers on the verge of getting that second walk already here in this game. Starting to lean a little bit more towards the batter's count, 2-1. Still a lot left in the at-bat, but still standing two outs here for the Wolverines.
Michigan 4-for-4 on the day with runners on base. Very impressive so far. The 2-1 pitch coming in from Johnson is fouled off, and he is now one strike away from getting out of this inning.
And that ball was flying into the Terrapin dugout. Looked like it almost hit somebody, but able to duck out of the way. Good instincts there from everyone sitting on the Maryland bench.
Two strikes, two balls, two outs. And now a mound visit will be coming in. Don't know if it was some, you know, communication issues, but this is an important pitch.
It seemed like Devin Russell just wanted a little time to chat over his now. He kind of walked over, talked for about 5 seconds, and is now on his way back to home plate.
Yeah, as the PA crew here play the Jeopardy, the final Jeopardy music, waiting for this important pitch to be thrown to see if Michigan can really, really pour it on and try to put this game as far out of arm's reach as possible. Really just ease the burden on Jacob Denner if it hasn't already. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Pitch coming in from Andrew Johnson, and that would be fouled off there by Will Rogers.
Will Rogers again, sitting 2-11 on the season. No change early in this game as he was walked. Now a 2-2 count, a little bit less manageable than the prior 2-1 count, sitting with two outs.
Michigan's drawn three walks already today, five extra base hits. The 2-2 pitch from Rogers is a swing and a miss, and that'll get out of the inning. Big presidential strike there. Strikeout for Andrew Johnson as he gets out of the inning. But damage was done. An 8-run inning for Michigan, really putting a massive lead already here early in this game. 8-0 lead heading into third. If you're Michigan, you can't ask for anything more.
No, and Michigan went through 13 at-bats in that inning, and 8 of the first 9 were all runs, and those last few left a couple stranded there for Michigan, but either way, Michigan able to get on the board in big numbers, leading 8-0, and Josh, you got to wonder, maybe with all that time off, Jacob Denner might be sitting a little cold here, might have to warm his arm
exactly,
back up.
Exactly, 100%. Denner definitely feeling a little cold here. You know, a lot of time sitting on the bench, but luckily his team provided him with a very nice cushion for him to come in cold with. Denner drops his ERA from 6.66 to 6.18 with two scoreless innings so far, only giving up the one hit to Kevin Keister. Maryland will have Elijah Lambros taking his first at bat of the game before heading back to the top of the order with Martin, who Denner hit to start off the game on an 0-2 count, and then Keister due up third in the hole.
Yeah, so
working its way back to the top of the order.
Yeah, those first two batters at the top of the order both made it on base safely. As you said, Josh, that first one was hit by a pitch on an 0-2 count, and then Keister was able to get on with a hit. So potentially, Maryland could see a little bit more action here with the top of the order coming. I mean, just looking at that top of the order, all of them sit around that 300 range. 299 for Martin, probably gone a little bit over 300 for Keister, who's sitting at 287 entering this game. But then Akopian at 376 and Hojnar at 264, all of them hitting quite well and getting on base nearly half of their at-bats. But nonetheless, Elijah Lambros at the bottom of the order will be up for Maryland here at the top of the third in Ann Arbor.
The center fielder for Maryland, Lambros, coming in with 30 strikeouts on the season. He's a very high strikeout guy, Lambros. Now up to actually 33 strikeouts on the season in 99 at-bats. So very high strikeout percentages. That second pitch is a swing and a miss. The count's now 1-1. High strikeout guy, 29 hits on the year. 444 slugging percentage and a 377 on-base percentage.
And in the first six outs of the game for the Wolverines, Jacob Denner has three to his name alone with three strikeouts so far. You have to wonder if Elijah Lambros will get that 34th strikeout here in this at-bat.
South Carolina transfer, as that pitch is low for ball two. Last season was third team all Big Ten, made 52 starts in 62 games, but is that South Carolina transfer from the state of Virginia. number one outfielder in the state in the class of 2021, number seven overall player. As that pitch there was ball for 3-1 count.
Seemed like that one hit the zone, but our home plate umpire decides otherwise.
I'd agree. A swing and a miss there, and is now a full count here. Opportunity to get an early strikeout here for Jacob Denner.
Yeah, definitely what Denner's looking for after sitting on the bench for a while, like we mentioned before. This would be a great way to warm his arm back up and get ready for the top of the Terrapins order. With
Lambros with two homers on the year as the payoff pitch comes from Denner, that's fouled off. 25 RBIs, so he is one of the two Terps that have the that share the team lead in RBIs coming into the game. Him and Sam Hosner each have 25 RBIs. Lambros with 11 walks on the year, looking at his potentially his 12th or get a base hit as the 3-2 pitch comes in from Denner, and that'll be ball four as Lambros takes his base heading back into the top of the order.
And Josh, you mentioned Lambros with 25 RBIs on the season is tied for the top for the Terrapins here, obviously leading off as the hitter unable to get an RBI in his at-bat to start the game, but able to get that walk, get on base, and he sits around a 377 on-base percentage, so good luck for him.
Back to the top of the order here, and that first pitch into Braden Martin was a strike.
Again, Braden Martin had that 0-2, Denner had that 0-2 count to Braden Martin, but Martin got hit by that pitch and was able to move on to first.
Second pitch fouled off there by Martin. The count's now 0-2. Yesterday's game had a combined 31 hits in the entire game. I mean, just unbelievable hitting production numbers by both teams. Today, Michigan with 7 hits already. Maryland just the 1 so far. So that 0-2 count comes in to Braden Martin. And that'll be grounded with double play opportunity here. Double play gets it done. A double play there for Michigan. Durnetti to Timbrook to Stanton. And Michigan is now all of a sudden with 2 outs in the inning. Michigan is one of the NCAA leaders in double plays turn. I'm sure we'll see some social media engagement. Michigan loves to post whenever they turn two because that is their specialty. That's their bread and butter, turning double plays, and that's what they did there.
Durnetti did a great job of scooping that up and doing a quick toss over to Timbrook before making the ultimate final play for that double play.
And that ball is chopped, and that'll be grounded to second base, who gets the out at first. Nice play there by Mac Timbrook to Dylan Stanton to get the third out of the inning. And just like that, Keister grounds out, and that is the second inning.
So Timbrook accounts for those last two outs, the first one on that double play. But that one kind of had an off-balance throw. Great throw by Timbrook to end the inning.
Yeah, excellent job by Timbrook. Excellent fielding. Michigan's fielding, especially in the infield, has been probably one of the underrated areas, or you know, one of the areas where Michigan's really excelled, lacking those infield errors. One of the other game I called this season for Michigan was against Toledo, and Jonathan Kim had 2 errors out in center field. You know, Michigan kind of shifting its outfield on the day, especially now with Kim's injury. Garcia now playing center. That's where Jonathan Kim normally is. But excellent infield defense there. And just like that, Michigan gets out of the inning, and Denner's pitch count is just 35 pitches through 3.
Yeah, especially there with the Wolverines, they've kind of struggled this year with the pitching. So having that consistent infield, especially when if a team is able to get solid contact but not get it into the outfield, typically that Michigan infield does a good job of making it in. But it looks like they might actually call back that last play as Michigan goes back out into the field.
Yeah, and Maryland looking to potentially use a challenge here as they're looking at replay options, it looks like here. They're checking the replay to see if the out at first is made. It was a nice effort there by Timbrook to get to Stanton. I thought he might have beaten him, but clearly Maryland thought otherwise.
Yeah, and it looked like that off-balance throw was definitely close there. Kind of hard to tell all the way from up here, but obviously Timbrook, again, with that great throw, just maybe a little bit late.
Yeah, Denner warming up, almost assuming that Keister beat out the throw. Eddie Hakopian will be up next. It's a close play, Maryland challenging. The out was the call in the field, so they need that conclusive evidence to overturn as the umpire crew is still looking at this play here.
This would be a pretty crucial call here with 2 outs. Eddie Hakopian, again, the leader of this Terrapin offense with a 376 average and 477 on base percentage, could potentially, if this call gets overturned, would have a runner at first, again, two outs, so still pretty manageable for the Wolverines. But if a ball gets into the outfield, I mean, that could ultimately be Maryland's
first run.
Yeah, extra
base could easily score. Yep. Kevin Keister here, hoping to get a replay on this call here, still trying to figure out the resolution is now their umpires are ready to make a verdict here, taking off their headsets from the replay situation, and let's see what the call is made.
They make their way back out onto the field.
And the call is out. And he's safe. So safe at first is the call. An awesome effort from Kevin Keister to ultimately beat out the throw. Very nice job there.
And Keister not giving up on the play.
Alive for Maryland.
Yeah, didn't give up on that play. Able to make it all the way to first. And ultimately a good challenge call there for Maryland as Michigan's defense was all the way back in their dugout, getting ready to kind of get ready for that offense in the bottom of the inning, but still two outs now, top of the third inning here for Michigan, still leading 8-0 as we look to Eddie Akopian, Maryland's top batter, up to bat now.
The three-hitter in Maryland's lineup is the first pitch to Akopian is delivered for a strike one.
Good framing there, as that seemed a little bit high and maybe a little outside, but that frame gets it in, and we'll get that first strike to Eddie Akopian as Denner will get ahead on this count here.
The 0-1 about to come in from Denner to Akopian, and that is fouled off on the right side into the Terps bullpen.
Yeah, all the way out into that bullpen. It was a good solid contact from Akopian, just not in the field to play. As the count's now 0-2, already behind, and Jacob Denner sits right where he wants him.
Denner at 38 pitches. That's just so far on the day. Very efficient outing so far as the 0-2 comes in. Akopian, that's high for ball one.
So again, Maryland has that runner at first, but now with a much more manageable count here for Jacob Denner looking to end the side, still with no runs on the board in the first three innings for Maryland.
Here's the 1-2 from Denner, and that is outside for ball number two.
Yeah,
the count's now even at 2-2.
Falling a little bit out of his groove here. Started 0-2, now 2-2.
Yeah, a little bit of trouble at the finish line here. So yep. We'll see if Denner can, you know, it's always tough to get these top hitters out, and Eddie Akopian is the top hitter on this Maryland lineup. So here's the 2-2 coming in from Denner, and that is low for ball three. So from an 0-2 count to a full count, we were just talking about how Denner's pitch count was so low, a full count walk would be not ideal. Here, the payoff pitch about to come in from Jacob Denner. Here's the full count pitch, and that is chopped fair right to Mac Timbrook, who was going to get the out barely. It was a high chopper. Timbrook had to quickly adjust and get the throw into Dylan Sandin, but did get the throw in time. I don't think that one will be reviewed. It was a nice play there by Timbrook to get the out. And now Michigan's officially out of the inning, unless... Don't see any challenges coming in. I think that was definitely the out at first.
Yeah, Mac Timbrook able to make that first play that was a little bit off balance, ultimately called back, but makes up for it there with kind of a high bouncing ball that he's able to grab and then throw all the way over to first, make the out. And again, Michigan now sitting at 8-0 with the lead going into the bottom of the third inning. They're sitting exactly where they wanted to, although this is a kind of similar position to yesterday when Maryland had that 5-0 lead, so... Again, tides could turn, but you never really know here.
Yeah, absolutely. Not as many dogs as I would expect here today for Bark in the Park. Definitely a handful that I'm seeing gazing out over the stands, but, you know.
The weather might have scared them away a little bit.
Yeah, no. Some people probably just don't want to bring their dogs out in this kind of misty, overcast.
A little bit cold, a little chilly.
Yeah, it's not super cold, but... Not you know, not one of those ideal baseball weather days, but really starting to kind of get into this meat of Big Ten season. This is Michigan's first home Big Ten series. MLB opening day was on Thursday, so it's really starting to feel like baseball season here.
It'll be Andrew Johnson still at the mound for the Terrapins, was able to kind of help aid that end of the inning. Ultimately had a base hit, but able to close out the inning without allowing any more runs after Logan Koester was able to give up 8 runs at the bottom of the inning. So Michigan still with their 8-0 lead in the bottom of the third here in Ann Arbor.
Yup. Now, Johnson will still be on the mound here as Mac Kimbrough comes into the plate. First pitch is outside for ball number one.
That one looked a little bit close to the zone, but
yeah, a little low and outside there.
Yeah, home plate judge decides to call a little bit outside. We'll call a ball on that 1-1-0.
Here's the pitch from Johnson. Showing bunt there was Timbrook, who did ground into that sacrifice bunt in his first at-bat. Had that sacrifice bunt to advance the runners to second and third.
Yeah, crucial at-bat from Timbrook, able to put those runners in second and third, ultimately led to that RBI double later in the inning. So Timbrook now 1-1.
And that pitch is lined out in the center field. Looks like Lambros is under it and does and makes the play for out number one.
A great hit. Good contact there from Timbrook. Just not able to get much distance and was a little too high. So pretty routine there play for Elijah Lambros as he able to get the first out here for the Wolverines. And, you know, Michigan's definitely looking to add a little bit more to that 8-0 lead that they already stand at, but unable to do so on that first at bat for Mac Timbrook.
The 9-spot hitter, Kyle Durnetti, is now up to the plate. First pitch is outside for Durnetti.
And his first at-bat, he got that walk, yep.
Yeah, we were just about to say, drew a walk in his first at-bat. He's looking to kind of get something going here for the top of the order with Garcia and Voigt due up next.
We've already been two times through this Wolverine lineup after Durnetti, so.
That pitch is in there for strike one.
As I was saying, strong job there for the Wolverines getting all the way through that lineup two times. Durnetti is the bottom of this lineup for the Wolverines. And as you mentioned, Josh A.J. Garcia and Mitch Voigt looking to come up after a little bit later in this inning. But with one out, may not make it to Voigt.
The 1-1 is outside. Home plate umpire for today is John Sapphire. First base, Sean Howard, Aaron Woodbury. Second base and third base, David Buck. Four-man crew for today's Big Ten clash. The 2-1 pitch is just catches the inside part of the plate there for strike number two.
Overall, it seemed like these umpires have done quite a good job today, especially with that first base call. A really hard one to tell on that Mac Timbrook throw, but
absolutely, yeah.
Good job reversing that call. Ultimately, probably was the right call on that one.
The 2-2 is belted, but does get under it there. Is Durnetti, and that'll be caught there by Luke Zeisloft for out number two.
Yeah, Luke Zeisloft, like we mentioned, only 7 games so far this season with 1 start, so this will mark his 2nd start of the season. Gets a nice routine fly out there as Durnetti is retired and will move to the top of the order for A.J. Garcia with 2 outs in the bottom of the 3rd. Michigan still leading 8-0.
Maryland looking for a 1-2-3 inning here. Andrew Johnson gotten 4 outs, no runs to his name so far, as Garcia fouls off the first pitch.
And Garcia had that ground out in the first and then a 2-RBI double back in the second, was just 2 of Michigan's 8 runs, but looking to continue his strong hitting that he's had so far this season, sitting at .429 in a smaller sample size, but still a great average.
The 0-1 pitch here is a little high for ball number one.
Yeah, as I mentioned, A.J. Garcia has that smaller sample size, only 21 at-bats so far this year with 5 starts and 16 appearances, kind of taking over for Jonathan Kim, who had that injury, seeing if he can get going here with a 1-1 count.
John sets and fires, and that is high, as Garcia had to duck out of that for ball number two.
Yeah, it seemed like that pitch was going right for Garcia's head, but good job ducking out of that way. Now leaning towards more of a pitcher's or a batter's count, 2-1.
Here's the 2-1 pitch. That is a little low outside for ball three. Chance for Garcia to get on base here with a walk.
Now Garcia
on his first at bat to first, and then had that 2-RBI double to really blow the game open in the second inning. So that pitch was fouled off by Garcia. Full count now. Johnson one pitch away from getting out of this third inning.
Could be 1-2-3 inning for Johnson as this full count pitch comes.
Here's
on
the
way.
Payoff pitch and a swing and a miss there from A.J. Garcia as pitching goes down 1-2-3. It's crazy. 2 1-2-3 innings on the bookends, but that second inning was absolutely busted open. 8 runs. Just absolute kind of very interesting kind of juxtaposition there. It's just not, you know, very quiet first and third innings, but very strong second inning where they just kept pouring it on Logan Koster.
Yeah, that second inning is still the main outlier here, as all five other half innings have zero runs. That's that bottom of the second inning is the only inning that has any runs in the right of them for the Wolverines. As moving to the top of the fourth here, again, Michigan leading 8-0 as Jacob Denner will enter his fourth inning pitched. Still holding out strong.
I'm just going to hope Denner can, with the lead, can kind of go long in this, try to, you know, hopefully get through seven innings, not trying to burn any arms to, you know, kind of stab off a win. See how Denner kind of holds up throughout the game, but it'll be very interesting.
And with those 42 pitches, Denner could potentially have quite a few more left in him to stay in as long as he can, like you said, to preserve maybe some of those arms that they have to try and get a win in the series. Down 0-1 after losing yesterday 11-9 to the Terrapins, but looking to make a run back in this series, already up 8-0. And as Jacob Denner warms up, we have Hojnar, Orr, and Kolarko up for the Terrapins, all of which went 0-1.
Yeah, 4-5-6 up for Maryland.
Be interesting to see if any of them can get their first hit or maybe their first time on the bases. As again, all of them are 0-1, but Hojnar will come up to bat here in that four spot for the Terrapins.
Hojnar up for Maryland after his first at bat got out in his first at bat. First pitch was in there for a strike. Hojnar gonna build off a strong outing yesterday. Swings and misses for strike number two.
And so swung at both of those first two pitches. That first one fouled off. The second one just completely misses, and Denner already sitting exactly where he wants to be ahead in the count.
Yeah, and an 0-2 pitch about to come in. The pitch from Denner gets a swing and a miss there from Hojnar. Chases outside, tried to check his swing, but it was well too late, and he knew it as well for out number one now.
Yeah, Hojnar didn't seem super confident in any of those three swings. That first one fouled off. That second one just completely whiffed on what was kind of a changeup there from Denner. That last one barely came around and was able to get that third strike. So three straight strikes for Denner, still preserving that pitch count, sitting at 45.
Here's pitch from Denner to Jacob Orr.
Jacob Orr sitting at 321 on the season.
Struck out in his first at-bat of the day. Denner with 4 Ks on the day. And that ball is lined out to center field. Garcia tracking and makes the catch. Garcia records out number two of the top of this fourth inning.
Yeah, good play there from A.J. Garcia. It was a little bit over his head, so he had to backtrack just a little bit. Looked like he almost didn't go far enough back, but able to extend his arm and get that second out of the inning. And now Maryland on the verge of going 1-2-3, just like Michigan did in the bottom of the third, as they're sitting still top of the four.
Yeah, Alex Clarko now up for the Terps. He lines one to Mac Timberk, who's going to throw it over to Stan. Get now out number three. Yet another 1-2-3 inning, and that was quick work for Jacob Denner. His pitch count remains very low.
They only had
50.
Only had 6 pitches in that inning. Those three strikes going to that first batter in Hojnar, and then Orr with that fly out to center, and Kolarko retired the side with that ground out to Timbrook. So again, good fielding there from the Wolverines as they get two of the outs, but Mac Timbrook sitting at quite a few strikeouts on the day today, doing a great job of keeping Maryland at bay and keeping this game in Michigan's favor, as Michigan still leads 8-0, as now kind of sitting more towards that top of the inning with Voit, Hrustich, and Priest coming up for the Wolverines, and all of which had one hit in that second inning. Mm-hmm. And Voit had that 2 RBI single in the second, in that onslaught of hitting that we saw in the bottom of the second inning that now gives Michigan that lead.
Yeah, and 2-3-4 coming up for Michigan. Voit, yeah, had a 2 RBI single in his second plate appearance after grounding out in his first at-bat. So looking to kind of build off, get a run on base for power hitter Steven Hrustic, who went yard off kind of the batter's eye out to dead center in his second at bat. So get a run on base and put your power guy up at the three spot.
And Andrew Johnson still sitting at a 0 ERA today, and even on the season, as he hasn't allowed any runs, but 9 innings pitched. So again, like you said, Josh, a couple innings ago, a smaller sample size for Andrew Johnson, but 2 strikeouts, 1 walk, and then a double on the air, and that's pretty much all that he's allowed.
Mitch Voigt now stepping up to the plate, the right-handed hitter going up against a lefty pitcher. This matchup should favor Voigt a little bit. Johnson trying to give a long stint for Maryland in that long relief after Koster just got absolutely rocked in the second inning. The first pitch from Johnson is low inside for ball one.
Again, like I mentioned earlier, Voigt sitting at the highest strikeout count of anyone on this Michigan lineup, but doesn't have a lot of walks, so that means he's really getting good contact with this ball, or he goes out trying.
1-0 pitch is inside for ball two.
Yeah, 6 walks on the year, as I was mentioning before, so if Voigt gets contact, it's likely in the field of play and likely on base, but otherwise could result in a strikeout.
The 2-0 pitch coming in from Johnson is inside. This is now a 3-0 count.
And it seemed like that all of these 3 pitches has been a little bit on the inside of the zone. These last two especially, that first one was a little high, but all of them sitting a little bit on the inside is now hitter's count for Mitch Voigt.
3-0 pitch is outside. A 4-pitch walk for Mitch Voigt.
So, I guess turning the tides a little bit. Only 6 walks on the season, gets his 7th there. I was just talking about how he normally doesn't get walked, but none of those pitches really in the zone anywhere for Voigt to hit, so he'll walk pretty easily over to first base. As now Hrustic, the Wolverines power hitter, is up to bat after he had that home run in the second. 9 home runs now on the season with 22 RBIs.
Now up to the plate for Michigan is Steven Hrustic with Voigt on first. Exactly what you want with a runner on base for Michigan's power hitter. He's brought his average up to .293 and now up to 9 homers on the season, 22 RBIs for Steven Hrustic.
Voigt leading off a little bit here on first base.
Second pitch is outside for ball number 2.
So now that's 6 straight balls in the zone for Andrew Johnson. Starting to get a little bit out of his groove here in the top bottom of the 4th.
The 2-0 pitch from Johnson is high. Ball number 3. The 7th straight ball for Avery Johnson cannot find the strike zone whatsoever right now. If I'm Hrustic, I would definitely be taking this pitch right here. Make Johnson throw me a strike. This pitch is way outside for ball number 4. 8 straight walks, or 8 straight balls, 2 straight walks. And now, stepping up to the plate is Colin Priest, who himself has a homer on the day.
So,
let's see if Maryland looking to make a pitching change or mound visit. Nothing in the cards as of right now.
Had some players warming up.
Not looking good. Michigan a chance to really, get this lead to double digits.
And the first pitch
flies up. That first pitch is popped way up high by Colin Priest. Trying to touch the sky there, but that play is easily made by Eddie Halopian.
So, pretty routine there play for the infield of Maryland, as now 1 out on the inning, and there'll be runners at 1st and 2nd.
Dylan Stanton now stepping up to the plate with opportunities for himself. It's 2-for-2 on the day with a single and a double. Stanton batted twice in the second inning, and now back up to the plate.
So as you said, 2-for-2, but we'll have a little bit of a mound visit here first with 1 out, able to get that first out in that last at-bat, but Dylan Stanton poses a big threat for Maryland with runners on 1st and 2nd, .289. And it seems like...
Stanton's brought his batting average up to, as you said, .289. very solid today, looking to try to cement his, you know, status in the lineup, you know, on a much more consistent basis, making just his 12th start of this season.
So Michigan on the day, still just 7 hits. I don't think they've recorded any since that bottom of the second inning. But again, 7 hits, 2 for Maryland, as Michigan has dominated the offensive board, still leading 8-0. So it looks like we will have a pitching change here for Maryland, as they have seen enough from Andrew Johnson. And now up.
Needy Johnson,
yep.
Will now be coming in. So back-to-back Johnsons here for the Terps. Johnson coming in with a 10.57 ERA. Gives up a 4.62 average runners on base, but again, a small sample size, giving up 9 earned runs in 7.2 innings with 8 hits, 11 walks.
Needy Johnson has the second highest ERA of any of the Terrapins. Again, like you said, Josh, smaller sample size, but nonetheless still a very high ERA. It seems like, not quite sure if this is a move to kind of keep their fresh arms for tomorrow and kind of let the rest of this game play how it is, but potentially in a couple innings here, if Michigan can get on the board, looking to run rule. But Michigan up, still 8-0 in the bottom of the fourth here in Ann Arbor on WCBN. Is it still a bit misty out today and still a lot of clouds, but like we've been mentioning all day, the dogs are out around the park here. So it'll be Stanton up to bat for the Wolverines, 2-for-2 on the day, as we were mentioning before.
Yeah, facing a new pitcher, he's a right-handed batter, so it kind of makes sense. You got a right-handed pitcher advantage. Meaty Johnson here, right-handed pitcher. And that first pitch is a base hit, line for a base hit, as runner will be waved home for Michigan. And that is a RBI base hit as Mitch Floyd scores. A nice base hit by Dylan Stanton to make this a 9-0 ball game.
And Floyd really showing his speed there as that third base coach waved him. He said, go, go, go. And don't even try and make an attempt to get the throw into home, as it'll hold off at the shortstop, number 3, Kevin Keister. And so just like that, Michigan is back on the board with runners still at first and second, and Cole Caruso will come up to bat, 1-for-1 on the day today.
Now up to bat is Cole Caruso for Michigan. The transfer from South Carolina upstate. Michigan now with 8 hits on the ball game to Maryland's 2, but 9 runs. That pitch is lobbed up in there for ball 1. 1-1 count now. Yeah, just a really, really solid contact going back to that Stanton RBI. Gets through, gets past Keister at short. Tough play for him to make, but in the left field for an RBI. That pitch is now the second ball, ball number 2. Third pitch of the at-bat.
So Stanton 3-for-3 on the day. Caruso, like I said, 1-for-1 with a double in the second and then a walk.
The 2-1 here is a swing and a miss there by Caruso.
Big swing there from Caruso.
Yeah, he was trying to nag a home run there, as we were talking about. Not a power guy, but just one home run in the year. But he saw his opportunity. He saw his name in lights there. Opportunity to make this a 12-0 ball game if it goes yard. That pitch is inside, and the count's now full.
Again, still one out for Maryland, so potentially more room for Michigan to do some damage with runners on first and second in the bottom of the fourth.
One pitch away here from potential bases loaded, if this is not a strike, as the pitch comes here from Johnson, and that is roped into right field, and that'll be fair. A fair ball hit there by Cole Caruso, as that is a double, as one run will score. Rustich scores with runners on second and third. Excellent hitting there from Cole Caruso, and this game is absolutely blown open.
Yeah, it's a stand-up double there for Caruso, no doubt about it. Knows for a fact he'll be able to make it in a second. Unfortunately, Michigan kind of holds off that third base runner. Is now Michigan will have runners on second and third, but able to drive one run in, and now Michigan has hit double digits, leading 10-0 in the bottom of the fourth with Will Rogers.
And Stan, he would have been gunned down at home if he had tried to get there. Definitely the right move by the third base coach there from Michigan to hold Stan there. Is now batting for Michigan is Will Rogers. Had a home run yesterday, a walk and a strikeout today. He's batting 208 on the year.
So not nearly as successful.
679 OPS, though.
Yeah.
But only less than 200 with runs in scoring position. It's a 1-0 pitch. Is in there for a strike. Counts now even.
Great slider there from Johnson to hit the middle of the zone.
Yeah, 1-1 pitch now in a 10-0 ball game with two runners in scoring position to potentially make this a 12-0 ball game. And that pitch is outside for a 2-1 count. Maryland not throwing their strongest arms, showing their best hand. How well Michigan's played after a disappointing blowing lead in the ninth, they've come out today with a vengeance. 1-2 pitch now, and that'll be a swing and a miss there from Will Rogers. His out number two is recorded.
Before the out was recorded, it was dropped there by the Maryland catcher, Devin Russell, but it will make that routine throw to first. So still runners at second and third for the Wolverines with now two outs. So
now Mac Timbrook will be coming up to bat for Michigan.
No chance here for Timbrook to get any kind of a sack bunt, sack fly, anything like that. Yeah. So he get two outs, but nonetheless, already done a little bit of damage.
Find a way to get him back. And they're going to go suicide squeeze here out at first with two outs. Questionable decision there. He tried bunting, was out at first. Don't know exactly what they were doing there with two out bunt. Easy out record at first there, grabbed by Mee Johnson. And out number three was recorded, and that's the inning.
Yeah, so Timbrook with two bunts on the day. That first one was successful, getting those runners to second and third and ultimately ended up scoring. But that bunt, like you said, Josh, was a little bit questionable as it was kind of straight to that pitcher there and was a pretty routine play there for Johnson. But nonetheless, Michigan holding a 10-0 lead. Now entering the top of the fifth with Jacob Denner still in the game and only 48 pitches. As you mentioned an inning ago, he only had six pitches in that inning. So really preserving his arm here and, again, preserving the rest of the Michigan bullpen as potentially able to save a couple arms for tomorrow as Michigan pretty much has this game right where they want it.
Looking at a potential opportunity for a mercy rule here. Michigan now up 10 runs, but still three innings to go.
So at this top of the fifth, we'll get the bottom of the Maryland order in Zeisloff, Russell, and Lambros. None of them have hits on the day, however, Lambros had that walk. The rest of them still 0-1 or 0-0.
And we are staring down the possibility of a rubber match tomorrow afternoon to take this series. Michigan with a very comfortable 10-0 lead here at Ray Fisher Stadium. Denner can kind of navigate these next two innings unscathed. His pitch count's less than 50. I mean, could potentially go 7-8 innings here, which would be a very quality start, a much-needed start for a veteran on this team. The senior now, Jacob Denner, will be facing Luke Zeisloff. Is that bad? And the first pitch is a swing and a miss by Zeisloff.
And Denner's been absolutely incredible today. Still allowed no runs on just two hits. Hasn't had a ton of runners in scoring position, which has been great to preserve that 10-0 lead.
The 0-1 pitch to Zeisloff is there for a strike. 0-2 coming now from Jacob Denner, who's been dealing today so far.
Four strikeouts on the day for Denner, so potentially looking at his fifth here.
0-2 pitch, and that gets the backwards K. The first looking strikeout, I think, of the day for Maryland as Denner gets the backwards K and out number one.
It's a great job there to keep Maryland off the bases. Gets that first out pretty easily on three straight strikes. As now Russell will come up to bat. And he sits kind of at the lowest average on the team, 178.
Yeah, Devin Russell, his first struck out in his first at bat swinging. Now hoping to try to f- figure out Jacob Denner in this second at bat as the first pitch went for a ball and the second pitch coming in now. That is popped up foul out of play. Looks like a fan might have caught it. Hard to tell from our vantage point, but
it seems like someone out in the press box over to our right, kind of on the outside side of it, might have gotten a hand on that and stopped it from going outside the park.
Here's a pitch from Denner, and that is roped into left field. Trying to make the play there is Hrustic, and that ball is gone. A home run for Devin Russell. Clears the left field wall, and Maryland gets its first run of the game. Just absolutely took Denner deep. Cleared the wall.
Much needed hit there for Maryland. Still, this is just their first run of the game. Devin Russell, he now has 4 home runs on the season. But again, still in a very comfortable position here for Jacob Denner, as that's just his 3rd hit that he's allowed today and just his 1st run.
Now batting for Maryland is Elijah Lambros, the 9th spot in the order with the 2nd up out of the game.
Before that at bat, Denner had gotten his average, or his ERA rather, all the way down to the mid 500s. Now back up to 6. Yep.
Swing and a miss there by Lambros.
Lambros again, one of the top hitters for the Terrapins with 25 RBIs on the season and his average nearing 300.
He's a nice bridge guy to the top of the order here for Maryland. I think that's kind of where they have him in that spot. Sometimes there's more value in the 9 than there is in maybe the 7-8. So you can get on base, and then you have some runners to capitalize on for the 1 and 2 spots. That pitch is there for strike. Swing and a miss there as the 1-2 pitch comes in from Denner, and that'll be popped up into right field. Mitch Voigt is under it and makes the play. Out number 2 is recorded.
Another nice hit ball there from the Terrapins. That one, obviously, quite a bit short compared to that last ball that we saw from Devin Russell. But Elijah Lambros hits that kind of straight out to Mitch Voigt, able to make a pretty routine play. Now 2 outs on the inning. However, a little bit of damage already been done, so Denner looking to get his 3rd out. Now back to the top of the order with Braden Martin.
Braden Martin, yeah, now up. And that ball is driven out into left field, but Hrustic looks like will be under it for out number 3. So despite Denner giving up the home run, 2 quick outs, keeps his pitch count down. Only 1 run given up there.
Yeah, on that first at-bat of the inning, he went 3 straight strikes for the strikeout, and then these last 2 at-bats were both flyouts. Pretty not terribly high in the count, so really only adds a few more pitches to his pitch count. And while he did allow that 1 run, really good for him to kind of stay low in that pitch count. Again, holding a big lead, 10-1 for Michigan as we enter the bottom of the 5th inning. And it will still be Meadie Johnson on the mound for Michigan.
Looks like Meadie Johnson will be coming out for the top of this inning. Brought his ERA down to 9.72 despite giving up. Was in relief of both of the runs that were scored from Maryland were credited to Andrew Johnson, so Meadie Johnson gave up 2 hits, but no runs were credited to his name. And Maryland with 3 hits, Michigan with 9 on the day. It's a 10-1 ball game heading into the bottom of the 5th.
And Michigan looking now to get back towards that top of the lineup. We'll start off with Durnetti, who's at the bottom of the lineup, but then back up to A.J. Garcia, Mitch Voigt, and then potentially Stephen Hrustic.
Got some kids in some obstacle course type competition going on. Don't know exactly who won. It was some potato sack type race.
Fun way to keep these fans entertained in what's been kind of a blowout game to this point. Seeing those kids compete in something is always fun for these fans. And I'm sure, again, having those dogs in the park and having them chill out here in this misty day has been exciting. Exciting enough, let alone a 10-1 lead for Michigan and Ann Arbor.
Absolutely. It's now come up to the plate for Michigan is Kyle Durnetti, the 9 spot hitter, as he takes strike 1.
Durnetti, 242 on the season, 0-for-1 today, as he has a walk and a strikeout, or a flyout, rather.
Yeah, flew up to left field in his 2nd at-bat in the 3rd inning.
But already down 0-2.
36 on base percentage for Durnetti. but down 0-2 in the count. And swings and a miss. Swing and a miss route number one there. Nice strikeout there by Meadie Johnson.
Yeah, Meadie Johnson, much-needed momentum booster there for the Terrapins, as he'll look to kind of keep that going through the stronger part of this Michigan lineup back at the top with A.J. Garcia up to bat. Garcia, 1-for-3 on the day.
Yeah, Michigan's lineup now heading the fourth time through the order as Garcia leading. It's the leadoff guy to start the game, so now Michigan back to the top of the order as he fouls off the first pitch.
Again, Garcia 1-for-3, had a ground out in the first, but then a 2-RBI double, as we mentioned, that second. Strikeout in the third has kind of slowed down this Michigan order, but looking to do a little bit more in his fourth at bat.
The 0-1 to Garcia is outside for ball number one.
So far, that's just the first ball that Meadie Johnson has thrown this inning. He had four straight strikes, including that strikeout to Durnetti. And now A.J. Garcia trying to claw his way back into this count.
The 1-1 is fouled off. 1-2 count now. On this kind of misty, overcast day, some early rain early in the day that's turned into a little bit of a soggy afternoon here, but not too cold. And that ball hits A.J. Garcia. As Garcia takes his base, an HBP there. Johnson just hit Garcia. Garcia turned and got him on the back. That is a hit by pitch. The leadoff man is now Mitch Voigt, comes to bat with a runner on base.
It seemed like Meadie Johnson was really getting into a groove there. Had five strikes and six pitches, but that seventh one just really got out of his hand and it hit. Garcia's now Mitch Voigt up to bat for the Wolverines.
Big lead there from Garcia.
That one nearly hit Voigt as well, actually. As you said, Josh, Garcia, quite a big leadoff as the first baseman for the Terrapins. Hakopian is kind of back there.
1-0 count here, and that ball is fouled off there from Mitch Voigt.
Mitch Voigt, 1-for-2 on the day with a ground out in the first. Had that 2-RBI double, or 2-RBI single, and then a walk just last inning.
1-1 count now to Mitch Voigt. And that hits him. Two straight hit by pitches. And now two runners on as Meadie Johnson has lost his command.
And it seems like the fans are getting a little bit upset about this one as well. Sticking up for their players. That's two straight hit by pitches to Garcia and Voigt.
Yeah, Harusic with an opportunity here with runners on first and just one out here. As we've talked about earlier, the power hitter on this Michigan team.
Still one out here in the inning. So
one out. Swing and a miss there from Harusic.
Yeah, with that one out, now runners on first and second, a chance for Michigan to continue their onslaught of hitting that they've had both last inning and then in the second inning with 8-2 runs. 8 in that second and 2 in that last fourth inning.
0-1 here two from Harusic, and that is grounded to Keister, who throws it to Hakopian for out number one, or out number two. Looked like it might have been a double play opportunity, but the ground ball was just a little slow moving, so wasn't able to get the double play. But Michigan does advance the runners and put Colin Priest in the opportunity with two runners in scoring position and two outs. So it was probably a sacrifice there. And we'll see how that ultimately gets scored. But, you know, if you're going to ground out, that's the way to do it. Looked like it could have been a double play opportunity and end the inning, but there's still two runners on base here for Colin Priest, who's been red hot today. Home run in his first at-bat of the game. Solo shot out to left center to open that second inning and really rattle Logan Koster. 1-0 pitch coming in from Johnson to Priester, and that curves in low for ball number two.
As you mentioned, Priest hasn't had quite the same impact that he had back in the second inning so far, 1-for-3 on the day, but that home run, his fourth of the season, was able to get that scoring started for the Wolverines and really set the tone for the rest of that inning.
The 2-0 is low for ball number three.
So a 3-0 count, pretty dangerous situation here. Could potentially have the bases loaded going into dealing
with Scanton. Very hitter-friendly count. questions. Do you give the green light here? And no green light taken. Strike number one.
So two outs still with runners on second and third, looking to add to the scoring as the Wolverines, who are up 10-1 in the bottom of the fifth.
Stan, who's 3-for-3 on the day, is on deck. And that pitch, the 3-1, is fouled out on the left side towards the Michigan bullpen and out of play.
And that ball was crushed. I mean, it went all the way past the Michigan bullpen.
Yeah, it just kept, like, hooking further foul.
Yeah, so, well, it was crushed. Foul on the count now full.
Full count, swing and a miss. And the inning ends just like that as Priest goes down on strikes. And that'll wrap up the fifth inning here at Ray Fisher Stadium. And we're going to take a little bit of a break midway through the game, and we'll come right back at to you for the top of the sixth.
We're back to the action here in Ann Arbor, as it will still be Jacob Denner at the mound, as the first pitch going in to Kaiser is a ball. So it'll be 1-0 is the count to Kaiser, who currently sits at a 3.01 average on the season. Was boosted a little bit today after going 2-for-2, a single and a single, as that second pitch goes in, and it will be another ball. So it'll be 2-0. Is the count.
Denner trying to go as long as possible here, make sure Michigan doesn't use any more of its arms in this game, up 10-1. And that pitch is fouled out in the third baseman. Cole Caruso will make the play on the foul out there. Out number one has been recorded as Keister is retired.
Yeah, really good tracking there from Caruso. That ball was hit really, really high, so... In fact, Will Rogers almost made his way out to get that snag out, kind of towards the block M on that third base line. But nonetheless, Cole Caruso able to get that out. And the first out of the inning for the Wolverines, still up 10-1 at the top of the sixth inning.
One out now, Denner working with as Eddie Akopian comes up to the plate and takes ball one.
Now, Akopian, 373 on the season, but 0-for-1 so far today. Has just that sacrifice ground out and then a ground out later. Is that pitch will go in 1-1 now. So, Akopian, one of the best hitters here for the Terrapins. Hasn't really got a lot going for them so far today, but looking to change that up.
On a 1-1 count here, and that ball is ripped by Akopian. And trying to make the play is Steven Hrustich, and he makes the catch. Out number two. Nice hustle there by Hrustich, but was able to pretty easily make that play. Out number two.
Yeah, great play there from Hrustich, as he's able to just kind of backtrack. It was getting a little bit close to the wall. Very well hit ball there, but able to make that play. Very routine there.
Yeah. Looked like it was maybe going to carry a little bit further than it did, but it got down and Hrustich was able to make the play. Thought it was definitely going to at least carry him off the wall, but did not. two outs now. Denner's pitch count just at 66 pitches now. That first pitch goes in for a ball to Sam Hosnar, who's now up for Maryland at the fourth spot. And that pitch is way outside there. Wild pitch there by Jacob Denner. Something that maybe he's more used to in the past, but has been rock solid today. Definitely, you know, Michigan's the stories of the day so far have been Michigan's second inning and Jacob Denner's quality start that he's been so yearning for. And that pitch is in there for a strike.
As you mentioned, Josh.
On the sixth inning, so Denner gets through this inning with three runs or less. That's a quality start. Looking to potentially go seven or who knows, even eight if he can retire Hosnar right here. And that ball is grounded, chopped to Stan, who's going to flip it to Denner, and he gets the out. A nice play there by Dylan Stan, who flips it to Denner at first, and that is out number three.
Yeah, great hustle play there from Denner, able to run all the way from the mound to first base and beat.
Michigan's defense has really been on display today, been an excellent performance defensively, made all the right plays, made no errors, especially that infield's just been rock solid.
Yeah, Jacob
Denner.
That's
kind of the core of this team is that solid infield. Been a major improvement from last season. Not that it was bad last season or defense, but it's really kind of instead of something that was very neutral, it's one of their advantages and strengths this year.
Yeah, Jacob Denner is still preserving that pitch count. And again, like you said, not really one of their strengths so far this season, but only has 69 pitches on the day in six innings. So really staying strong, and that infield definitely helping him out a little bit. As well, Denner did make that last play, made it look pretty easy for him as he ran on over to get that final out. But, you know, really good play all throughout the Michigan infield. From Stanton.
Looks like we will have a new pitcher here for Maryland in this inning. Evan Smith, the freshman left-hander from Huntingtown, Maryland, will be pitching for the Terps, number 20, for those keeping track of the Maryland roster.
And Evan Smith comes in today with a 5.79 ERA in just three appearances and four innings pitched. So really, really small sample size. But the freshman is looking to maybe a little bit of a good experience here in Ann Arbor as Michigan still leads 10-1. Now heading into the bottom of the sixth inning. Still on that watch for a run rule, or potential run rule, rather. As coming up for the Wolverines in their order would be Stanton, Crusoe, and Will Rogers. And Stanton 3-for-3 and Crusoe 2-for-2 on the day, so both are still perfect to this point. So what's been kind of the lower part of Michigan's batting order is really heat up today.
Yeah, I mean, it's really been Stan and Caruso as it anchors at the 5 and 6 spot. Rogers, Timbrook, and Drinetti, you know, they've had their impacts and contributions, but neither of them at the 7, 8, 9 have gone a hit. And then 1 through 4, each one hit. But Stanton with 3-for-3 on the day, Caruso 2-for-2. And now Stanton will be coming up to bat here for the Wolverines. The first pitch is taken low by Stanton for ball one. Made that nice fielding play at first to flip it to Denner to end the top of the sixth. Now we're here at the bottom of the sixth inning here. As the 1-0 pitch is fired, and that is belted. Looks like it's going to hook foul, though, but a solid contact there from Dylan Stan, but that ball is not in play.
Yeah, Josh, you mentioned that was great contact from Dylan Stan. It goes all the way out.
Yeah,
it's
got a little bit just ahead of it.
Unfortunate hook there.
Always interesting to mention of a baseball field, but that one was definitely way pulled foul. It's the 1-1. Well, it's fouled off there by Stanton.
That one could not have felt good as it bounces kind of on home plate and then hits his back.
Yeah.
Takes a second to walk it off, kind of walks around, and then make his way back.
Get ready to set and get in here. Pitch clock didn't reset, but I think the umpire knew that he was taking a little time out after that foul ball. As the 1-2 comes in from Meaty Johnson, or not Johnson, where that ball is an error off the third baseman. Jacob Moore could not make the fielding play. Pitch there thrown from Evan Smith, but just a little clumsy fielding error as now Stan takes first base.
And we've seen pretty good fielding. I mean, the pitching just hasn't really been there for Maryland, but the fielding has been quite good, making good decisions. Unfortunately, that one will mark down as the first error today.
Yeah, the first error of the game, it's been a pretty clean fielding game, all that, but just Jacob Moore could not make the play there for the Terps.
It's now 0 outs with a runner on first.
first pitch thrown by Evan Smith is high for ball one, Nicole Caruso. So, yes, while that should have been a routine play at third, Stanton gets on base once again.
So, Stanton now will stick at 3-for-3 on the day, but has made it on base all four at-bats.
The 1-0 pitch to Caruso is in there for a strike. Looks a little bit low, but did catch the zone in the umpire John Sapphire's view.
As we mentioned, Stanton and Caruso have been two of the top hitters today for the Wolverines. Two doubles on the day with two RBIs for Caruso.
Here's the 1-1, and that is looking outside. It's a ball.
Now again, runner at first with no outs. Michigan kind of heading towards the bottom of their lineup, who hasn't been quite as successful as the top, but nonetheless still holding a
10-1
lead.
2-1 pitch here is roped into left field, and that is just foul. Down the left field line. It was hooking that way and ultimately landed in foul territory. Not a huge gap there between the wall, the barrier in left field, and in the foul line, but the ball did find that gap there and resulted in a foul ball.
Yeah, that was a rocket from Caruso, yeah. Just landed just kind of in that, like you said, that little sliver in between.
He's seen the ball well, though. Seen the ball well. Yep. It's now a 2-2 count to Cole Caruso. Here's the pitch, and that is hit into right field, and that will get down past Braden Martin, and Caruso is looking to go from second as Stanton holds up at third. Another double from Cole Caruso, his third double of the game.
Yeah, Cole Caruso is just laying these balls out. I mean, he's 3-for-3 on the day, and all three of those hits have been doubles. The only other at-bat has been a walk, so, I mean, he is just doing a great job of finding exactly where it needs to be in the outfield. I think a lot of them have been kind of in those corners, not able to get an RBI. He had one RBI in each of the last two doubles. That one obviously doesn't, just because Stanton was standing at first, but able to advance the runners with no outs to second and third base.
Yeah, absolutely, and now second and third, no outs for Will Rogers. And that first pitch is in there for a strike.
Seemed like it caught the inside of the zone there, but Will Rogers 0-for-2 on the day, so not a strong day for him with a walk in the second and two strikeouts after that, but with runners in scoring position, maybe more of an
incentive. Surprised if he tried to show bunt, and that first pitch is foul way up high into right field. We'll see if Stan tries to make the sacrifice tag, and he will go, and they are not even going to try to throw home as a run scores here for the Wolverines. Yeah, Dylan Stan scores on the sacrifice fly from Will Rogers. Rogers gets the job done, and it is now an 11-1 ball game.
Interesting play there from Maryland. I would have thought they maybe would have tried to advance.
Didn't see that ball far from right out field. Into right yeah. field. Martin just didn't even bother trying to make the play. Probably just didn't trust his arm there. Let the run score.
Nonetheless, kept the runner at second, so a partial win for Maryland, not advancing both runners. It will just advance.
Yeah, it wasn't a double tag up there for the Terps. That first pitch fired in from Evan Smith to Mac Timbrook is outside for a ball.
And Mac Timbrook also 0-for-2 on the day. The bottom three batters of this Wolverines lineup are all 0-for-2.
Timbrook with the sacrifice in his first at bat, and that pitch is well inside there for ball number two.
So yeah, as you mentioned, had that sacrifice play back in the second to advance the runners, but the bottom of the lineup looking not as quite as consistent as kind of that middle and that upper part of that Wolverine batting order.
The 2-0 pitch from Smith is grounded toward second base to Hosnar, who's going to flip it to first and get the out. Oh, and they're going to rule him safe. They're going to rule Timbrook safe at first base. It was a close play. We'll see if Maryland tries to challenge. That was a very close play. Everyone's safe. And Caruso advances to third, and the umpires will come together. I personally thought he was just barely
too,
out.
Yeah.
Certainly close for his umpire rules him safe, so we'll see if they change the call.
Yeah, Sam Hojnar kind of lagged a little bit on that play. He was kind of running and then threw it a little off balance, but, I mean, he was right there, so it should have been a pretty easy play from
the
second base.
Look at this. I personally think we're going to try to see some replay. It looked like he was probably it was a tight play. I think he was just out, but you never know. We'll try to look at a replay on some of these other cameras here to see if he beat out this throw. Would be an excellent hustle play. good hustle play regardless for it to even be this close. Regardless of the runner advance to third, and it's very close. Super close. I think he might be safe.
Yeah.
I don't think they're going to have enough to overturn it. It looks like it's bang, bang, and simultaneously, Timbrook hits the bag at the same time as the ball hits the glove of Eddie Halopian.
Yeah, kind of looking at this replay that we have next to us up in the booth, it looks really, really close. It looked like it kind of hit, like you said, Josh, bang, bang.
The ball just arrives, and I think they're going to have to rule that. I don't think you have anything to overturn.
No, I don't think so either.
Call on the field, I think safe is the correct call. They're going to go to review, and I think it's going to stand. And that means you would have first and third with one out. Caldernetti will be coming up to bat. Umpire's taking off the cameras now, and we'll see what they rule. I think safe will be the call. You think the same, Zach?
Yeah, I think the same. I mean, we saw on the replay and kind of live, it looked very similar timing, but.
Here is the call coming in. Runner is safe. Excellent hustle play, officially confirmed by Mac Timbrook. An infield single, beat out the throw, and first and third, one out.
Yeah, so like you said, Josh, one out now for the Wolverines with runners still in scoring position. The runner advanced from second to third as we reach the bottom of the lineup with Durnetti. Durnetti has a chance to drive in Michigan's potential 12th run. Here's we have a runner again, like you said, on first and third. Durnetti
yeah, we'll
up.
See if they maybe try to get the out here. Not a force at home. First pitch to Kyle Durnetti is a strike.
And Durnetti 0 for 2 on the day. Had a walk all the way back in the second and then a flyout and a strikeout. So, again, this bottom of the order not been quite the same as the top of the order for the Wolverines.
0-1 into Durnetti is low for a ball.
Durnetti 240 on the season. An overall pretty consistent hitter with an on-base percentage of about one-third of the time. It's gone down a little bit today, though.
1-1 count. And that pitch is outside by Smith. Evan Smith, 2-1 count now with a runner on third.
And Russell kind of had to reach out for that pitch there.
Yep. Could have easily been a wild pitch there. And that ball is fouled off there by Durnetti, and it's now a 2-2 count.
So good job here by Evan Smith getting him to swing at that pitch with a more manageable count at 2-2. One out, a strikeout would be pretty detrimental to the Wolverines here trying to keep their scoring going, already up by 10, though.
And here's the 2-2 pitch. That'll be fouled off to stay alive here.
That one also looked like it got a little bit of a piece of Durnetti after it hit home plate. Might have hit, like, his arm or his leg or something, and could not have felt great, but nonetheless, count remains 2-2 with one out in the bottom of the sixth here.
Even count, bottom six, one out. Here's the pitch to Durnetti, and that is fouled off once again.
Durnetti staying alive here. Two straight foul balls. Well, three straight foul balls. Two foul balls at two strikes. As again, one out in the bottom of the sixth. Michigan still leading 11-1. In what's been a pretty one-sided affair here at Ray Fisher Stadium.
Absolutely. Two balls, two strikes, one out. We'll do it again. And that pitch is way outside. Nice pick there from Devin Russell. On an outside pitch to prevent any type of pass ball, wild pitch type scenario where Stan would love to potentially be heading home. One pitch away from loading the bases. Here with a full count pitch from Evan Smith. And here's the payoff pitch. And that'll be hit foul, pop foul. Halopian drops the ball, was going to make the grab, drops the ball. Does not make the play, went in and out of his glove. Durnetti stays alive, just barely.
Still more foul balls.
Foul got down, and Halopian, nice effort, but could not come up with the catch. Yeah, it would have been out number two.
Halopian had a pretty tough play there to try and get that. Just couldn't come up with it.
The full count pitch with one out, and that ball is hit way out into left field. Zeislav is looking, and that ball will be caught there by Elijah Lambros, but a run will score on the sacrifice fly, and it is now a 12-1 ball game for Michigan. Durnetti with the sack fly, bringing home Dylan Stanton.
So although Durnetti
Cole Caruso, rather.
Yep. Although Durnetti will go still 0 for 2 on the day, that sack fly gives him an RBI. So Michigan now, as you said, Josh, leading 12-1 here in the bottom of the sixth, and still a runner on first, but now at the top of the order with A.J. Garcia for the Wolverines. Wolverines now up to 11 hits on the day in their 12 runs.
Yeah, it's been a dominant performance, starting with Denner at the mound and just that massive second inning, and Michigan's been able to tack on some runs in these following innings. Two in the fourth, two in the sixth. That first pitch goes into Garcia as a ball, and the second pitch coming in now, and that is fouled off, coming in inside. See, it was a little shaken up and rattled there. Could have easily hit his hands, but seems like he came away with it unscathed, which is certainly good.
Yeah, seems like it didn't quite hit his hand, but might have hit kind of that skinny
part
of
the
bat.
Inside of the bat.
Yeah,
definitely
does not feel good.
Dangerously close there. Yep. It's the last thing you want here in Michigan, and a big advantage. And that ball be grounded towards Keister, trying to make the play to Garcia, and he got him. Nice play there by Keister to Halopian. Get it, Garcia out just in time. It was a slow rolling ground ball, but at just enough speed where Keister was able to catch it, turn, fire to Halopian, and make the play.
It's a great play there by Keister. It was kind of a really slow moving ball. He had to move up to it. And then after he finally moved up to it, he flung it all the way over to first and got that much-needed third out. But Michigan still able to tack on two more runs to their lead as we'll enter the top of the seventh inning with Michigan up 12-1. Again, that hit differential is 11-3 as Jacob Denner has had himself a day. Still in the game, he's going to start warming up at this top of the inning now. 5.68. is his ERA, 5.68. And really only one run on that day, so he's really held the Terrapins at bay with just that one home run as the seventh inning stretch will commence.
They're playing take me out to the ballgame in the top of the seventh. What's going on? Maybe they're preparing for a potential mercy rule. Still a little bit unclear, but yeah, I mean, Denner with the opportunity, if this game does go to a mercy rule, still kind of unclear because it has to be agreed upon by the coaches. But an opportunity here for Jacob Denner to potentially pitch a seventh inning complete game, which would, you know, be a very nice achievement. He's brought his ERA down almost a full point. So been a very, very solid effort. Looks like mercy rule is a possibility here on this Saturday afternoon, given the fact that they're playing Mr. Brightside in seventh inning stretched up in the top of the seventh, almost preparing in a way for the possibility of this game to end.
Yeah.
If Maryland played two runs, you know, we'll head into the bottom of the seventh, but if not, mercy rule seems like a very distinct possibility here this afternoon. Both teams just trying to conserve their arms in this blowout game. But we'll see how Denner can fare trying to close this game out with the mercy rule possibility.
It'll be Jacob Orr up to bat here for the Terrapins, 0-2 on the day with a strikeout and a flyout.
The first pitch there to Jacob Orr is fouled off. Maryland going 5-6-7 to start this half inning.
These 5-6-7 batters all 0-2 on the day, so one of the weaker parts of what's been a pretty stagnant Maryland offense.
Yeah, and to stay in this game and prevent a mercy rule, Maryland is going to need to get some runs in this part of the order and get some production quick. They're going to need it now. A 1-1 count here from Jacob Denner as he sets. His looks, fires outside. Rogers tried to frame it, but definitely outside for ball two.
Yeah, Will Rogers made a lofty attempt there to frame it, kind of from a very high and outside ball to maybe inside the zone, but nonetheless, 2-1.
Here's the 2-1 coming in from Denner, and that will, very nice pitch there from Denner to get the call there. Strike two.
So Jacob Orr kind of sitting not exactly where he might like at 2-2. Have to try and keep himself alive here in this at-bat.
Here's the 2-2 pitch, and that is fouled off by Orr. Staying alive in this at-bat. Denner's pitch count now 74 pitches. Very, very efficient outing from the Michigan veteran. Senior leader on this team. Very strong outing today. Not that, you know, with the team needing it in terms of runs, but here's the ball grounded from Timbrook to Stan to get out number one. Michigan looks like they're going to be two outs away from a potential mercy rule win. They didn't need Denner's best, but that's what they got. And he helped set the tone so far for Michigan to allow Michigan to kind of pile on those runs and not have to worry about giving up what happens yesterday when they gave up 11 runs in 9 innings.
Right, and Jacob Denner, with only 9 appearances in 25 innings, doesn't normally pitch this much in every game. Really only averages about 2.5 innings per game.
Kind of a mixed like relief slash starter role.
Yep.
You know, was a starter last year, so often that Sunday starter on a lot of those rubber matches. But, you know, I think what, you know, they've kind of been tinkering with him in the bullpen sometimes. That pitch would go in there for a strike, and it's now a 1-1 count. But I think, you know, with Denner, you know, this is a big outing for him. You know, they've been using him in different circumstances. But the key, what's been able for him to thrive, is his pitch count's so low. I mean, 77 pitches, you know, through 6.1 innings. Opportunity to go 7 here, and that ball is outside. Counts now 2-1.
Yeah, Denner really, really, like you said, Josh, he's just shown his best today. He's brought his ERA all the way down to 5.62.
Here's the pitch, and that'll be fouled off there by Alex Colarco. Colarco on the day, only 2 at-bats, struck out and grounded out in his 2 plate appearances. Maryland's bats, you know, just 3 hits, not too many walks, only 1 walk given up by Denner, so not many base runners. That ball is fouled off there on the 2-2. So Denner has really done a good job of limiting traffic on the bases. And, you know, given after first inning had the hit by pitch and then a single, instead he's been rock solid other than the home run he gave up. Here's the 2-2 coming in from Denner, and that will be chopped down towards third base. That is fair. Oh, it'll be foul. Just foul there. Cole Caruso has a little embrace there with the third base umpire. trying to make sure he doesn't get hit. The count does remain at 2-2, so Denner has one ball to work with.
And Josh, as you said, Denner's had a great day, but the infield also done a really good job of keeping him in. Anytime the ball got into the infield, really no infield singles here today, and Mac Timbrook, especially at second base, has done a great job.
The 2-2 coming in from Denner. Did he go? He did not. Colarco held up there. Avoided going down, swinging on the check swing. So it's now a full count here. Denner with a chance to get the second out. Get one out away from a mercy rule victory. Here's the 2-2. Or 3-2. And that'll be ball 4.
It's unfortunate. Outing there for Denner was a very, very long at bat.
And lengthy at bat. His pitch count's definitely now ballooned a little bit. Now up to 83 pitches, still very within the realm, and they're going to try to only use him the rest of the way in this inning.
Now one out. Colarco is the lone base runner at first, as we're still kind of in this bottom of the Terrapin lineup.
Now it looks like we have a pinch hitter for Maryland. That pinch hitter will be number 4 on the Terps, Jordan Crossland, the freshman infielder from Suffolk, Virginia. One out. Michigan a double play away from ending this. They love turning those double plays. We'll see if they can get there.
And Crossland, a typical pinch hitter here for the Terrapins. He's actually started 10 games and appeared in 15 with a .324 average.
Second pitch there after strike one is called strike two. Then one strike away once again from getting out number 2 in this half inning.
As I was mentioning, Crossland, .324 average, but .444 on-base percentage, so gets on the base quite often, has provided a good spark here for the Terrapins throughout the year.
The 0-2 from Denner is a little low. Riders able to make the stop. It's now a 1-2 count for Crossland. Denner looks, checks on the mound. Sets, fires in the 1-2. That ball is fouled off.
These Terrapin batters are doing a great job of staying inside these counts. I mean,
yeah,
the last at bat,
staying alive, you know, as Denner's sort of wearing a little bit. You don't want to necessarily use another pitcher. It looks like a little bit of movement going on in this Michigan bullpen if Denner does run into a little bit of trouble. We'll see if anything develops. But here's the 1-2. That ball is fouled, trying to make the play, and that ball will just land in the Maryland bullpen. But boy, was running over. Wasn't, you know, well out of the reach of making the play as that ball landed well into the Maryland bullpen on the right side.
This is two straight at bats now that the count has been 1-2.
Yeah,
still sits at 1-2, but yeah, these batters really staying in, hitting a lot of foul balls and wearing down Denner a little bit here.
Yeah, here's the 1-2 from Denner, and he gets a ground ball to Timbrook, and that'll be grabbed by the shortstop and dropped at first. The out was made at second. Giannetti ended up catching it and stepping on the bag, made the throw to first. Not in time, or Stan was not able to make the play. Would have potentially ended the inning and even the game, possibly. Doesn't make the play. Would have been out at first if the play was made there by Stan. It was a little off by Giannetti. Kind of a weird chopper right at second base.
Yeah.
So the lead runner was out, but there's still two outs. Denner's pitch count now up to 89 pitches, so probably only got a couple batters left. But there's two outs in this inning. And that is strike number one there. That goes to Devin Russell, who's now batting for Maryland.
Russell
hit that
home
run, that solo
yeah.
shot.
Yep.
The only run, you know, took Denner deep out to left. Here's the 0-1. And that'll be grounded on the third base side foul. So Michigan one strike away from getting out of this inning.
And again, kind of on that last play, we saw that ball bounced right to that second base, and Giannetti able to get that first out, but that second one unable to get there. Nonetheless, Denner is, like you said, Josh, just one strike away from a strikeout that would end the inning. 0-2 is the count.
The 0-2 from Denner is a swing and a miss, and that will be the top of the seventh as Michigan leads 12-1. We'll see if there's any discussion on whether or not this will be a run rule. Still unsure of the policies, but Michigan up 12-1. It's the Maryland fielders will run out, so it doesn't seem like there will be a run rule as we head into the bottom of the seventh.
Yeah, Denner does a good job staying alive in that inning. Had a lot, like we said, a lot of foul balls, so really kind of charged his pitch count up a little bit, but they will elect to go into the bottom of the seventh inning here as Michigan will kind of get into getting past the beginning of their lineup, as Voigt, the second batter in this lineup, will be the leadoff hitter, with Rustich and Priest following after that, and then back into Stanton and Crusoe, who both have three hits on the day. So, really good chance here that Michigan could add even more runs to what's been, so far, a 12-1 outing for the Wolverines, and heading into the bottom of the seventh. I mean, a lot going right for Michigan today.
Yeah, no, it's been a dominant performance from Michigan, a much-needed bounce back after two brutal losses, getting absolutely demolished at home against Michigan State in the midweek. Didn't count for conference standing. Looks like we're going to have some substitutions here for Michigan, so, and Maryland as well, so we'll have to check on those. Some of these defensive substitutions coming in. Looks like Orr is going to be subbed out. Third base. And replacing him will be Carlo. Randy Carlo IV will now be at third for Maryland. Some defensive substitutions on their side.
So, potentially with the game opened up here, 12-1, this is a good chance to bring in a little bit of inexperience into both teams' defenses. And especially on a day where this game has never really been all that close, it's a good chance to bring in, again, these pitchers that we've seen from Maryland, including the one up right now, who's Evan Smith, pitched last inning. Good experience for him. Good experience for a lot of these infielders who may not get a lot of chance to play. But nonetheless,
Crossman will be at left field as well. Defensive substitution as sort of Crossman moves to left. Mitch Voigt steps up to the plate for Michigan. And that first pitch is outside there for ball number one to Voigt.
Mitch Voigt so far still 1-for-2 on the day. In the fifth inning, he was hit by a pitch right after his teammate AJ Garcia was hit by a pitch. Looks like it'll be a 2-0 count.
Automatic
here.
It's an automatic ball.
And so, like I said, 1-2. Had a single all the way back in the second. That was a 2 RBI, but a walk and a hit by pitch in the last two at-bats.
2-0 is a swing and a miss.
Evan Smith looking to make his way back after falling back 2-0, now 2-1. Voigt kind of keeping his average at the same, 339. It was 336 coming into this game today. Nonetheless, here comes the pitch.
Yeah, here's the pitch. The 2-1 is outside for ball number three. Voit with a very friendly hitter's count.
We'll see again. Typically not a batter that walks all that much, has one today, but only 7 on the season. So 6 coming into this game, looking at a potential 8th, as looks like Evan Smith will take a second.
Yeah, pitcher timeout. Probably saw the pitch clock, staring down the possibility of a pitch clock violation here. The 3-1, Ingram Smith is hit by Voit out into right field. Martin, it goes over the head of Martin. Oh, they ruled time.
They are going to wave it dead here. But it looks like the third base official is going to call that pitch clock that we were talking about right before that pitch was hit.
So they rule a pitch clock violation. So instead of a base hit, it's just a walk. Would have been probably the same result. Might have been able to take 2. But
yeah.
A pitch clock violation there. Sloppy there by Evan Smith.
Looked like Voit, he started slowing down going into first just because he called the home plate umpire.
Yeah,
but
he definitely did.
I mean, I would not have been surprised if Voit would have tried to go for a double there because it went all the way back and hit the left or the right field wall. Mm-hmm. But Rustich up the back, not for the Wolverines.
Absolutely. Here's the pitch. And that is belted out by Steven Hrustich. Foul. He gets a hold of that here. Hrustich, the number 3 hitter for Michigan, takes the first pitch deep and foul.
We've been mentioning all day Hrustich, this main power hitter for the Wolverines with 9 home runs, including 1 today, and 22 RBIs. And on that home run, he had 2 RBIs. So looking for maybe 2 more with Voit sitting at first base.
The 0-1 to Hrustich is just high and goes for ball 2.
So Voit hanging out at first base, still no outs for the Wolverines as they're up 12-1 in the bottom of the 7th inning. Looking to maybe add to that lead a little bit.
The 1-1 to Hrustich is outside for ball number 2. Starting to work towards that hitter's count, as it does not appear that there will be a run rule in this game. I think in Big Ten play, a lot of the run rules usually occur in the non-conference play, but I think in Big Ten they just don't do a mercy rule.
It's a good experience. Like to get these players
good
some more experience.
Yeah, a good chance to get some of these guys' experience. It's a swing and a miss there by Steven Hrustich. Evens the count at 2.
And Steven Hrustich doesn't have all that many strikeouts, 19 on the season. It's kind of near the average of this Michigan lineup. But today he's been absolutely solid with a walk and a home run. He's 1-for-3 on the day.
The 2-2 from Hrustich is outside for ball number 3. We have a full count coming in. Full count pitch here. The runner on first, Voit on first. Here's the pitch coming in from Evan Smith. Swing and a miss there by Steven Hrustich, and that'll be out number 1.
So just as we were talking about it, he gets that 20th strikeout that he's had on the season, and in fact, that'll be Evan Smith's first strikeout of the day today, the pitcher for Maryland.
Yeah, coming into the game with 7 strikeouts.
Yep.
So that'll be his 8th of the season. Smith, freshman, just finding his way onto the team. And these are meaningful outings for someone like him, just to get that experience. And, you know, maybe that's part of the reason why the Big Ten does not have a mercy rule. I think the SEC does. Big Ten does not. One out of the inning, Smith 2, Colin Priest, and the first pitch is low for ball 1.
Colin Priest, 1-for-4 in the day, and this top of the lineup for Michigan hasn't been all too strong. Each of them kind of have one hit that was going through that frenzy of hits in the second inning where they got 8 runs, but again, Priest 1-for-4 with just
a
home run.
And that pitch catches the corner for a strike to Colin Priest, and the count's now 1-on-1.
So yeah, that home run for Priest all the way back in the second, his only hit of the day today with a line out, pop out, and strike out in his last 3 appearances. But one hit, one RBI.
1-1 pitch is a double play opportunity. Hojnar to Keister to first base to Hakopian, and that'll be a double play to end the 7th inning.
Great play there. I mean, pretty routine double play, although maybe not always a double play is routine. Able to flip it from second base to that shortstop who was standing at second all the way to first. Very easy play there for Maryland to retire the side.
All right, we will take one more break heading into the top of the 8th inning here at Rayfield Stadium. 2 more innings to go here in this game as Jacob Denner walks out. Welcome back to the top of the eighth inning here at Ray Fisher Stadium, where Michigan leads Maryland by a score of 12-1. Michigan still riding that dominant second inning, an eight-run second inning where they absolutely chased Logan Koster. The first pitch, Maryland, a leaping attempt there by Mitch Voigt to try to get the first out of the inning. It's unsuccessful. Foul ball there, hit by Maryland. Maryland's Eddie Lambros, or Elijah Lambros.
Mitch Voigt kind of flipped over that wall a little bit there.
Wall, yeah.
Try and make a diving play for his team, but comes up just a little short. He maybe would have been able to get it, but heck of a play to try and get that out.
Yeah, and Denner with that pitch count of 92, looking at probably this being only one or two more at-bats probably. Once he probably hits 100 pitches, that's probably going to be it for him. A little pass ball there on the 0-1, so the count's now 1-1.
Elijah Lambros on the day today is 0-1. Had a walk back in the third and a flyout in the fifth, as this will be the third time through Maryland's order before we head all the way back.
The 1-1 pitch from Denner is in there for a strike. Counts now 1-2.
Again, up after this will be Braden Martin, and Kevin Keister at the top of the order, and Lambros looking to get Maryland's offense going a little bit here late in this game.
1-2 count here. The pitch from Denner is fouled off there by Elijah Lambros, who stays alive. Kind of see a little bit wearing, not able to get some of those pitches past. Denner with 6 Ks on the day. A lot of those, you know, forwards Ks, strikeouts, you know, swing strikeouts. Giving up the one home run as the only run there. Other than that, it's been a very solid day. It was Russell who had the home run as a foul ball there by Lambros, who is in the 9 spot, staying alive here.
These Terrapin batters, especially in Lambros right now, and then the last half inning in the bottom of the 7th, or top of the 7th, rather. A lot of them are really staying alive, getting these foul balls to make Jacob Denner's life a little bit harder as he's really getting close to that 100-pitch count, now at 97.
Here's the pitch from Denner. That ball is hit high in the air into left field. Russ is trying to get under it, and it makes the catch at the warning track. Nice play by Steven Rushes at the warning track. And on that high fly ball, we will see if that's the end of Jacob Denner's day, as his pitch count's right around 100.
Michigan
now at 98. So we will see if they make a call to the bullpen, trying to figure out who's warming up in the pen for Michigan. Looks like this might be Denner's last batter facing that lefty-lefty matchup. Braden Martin, the left-handed hitter, before 2 righties. So it makes sense that this would be Denner's last batter of the day before you have a right-handed pitcher coming in. And that ball is hit. A nice play defensively by Cole Caruso, who gets it over to Dylan Stan at first to get out number 2. A nice play there from Cole Caruso to rob Braden Martin of a base hit.
That was a really hard hit ball straight to Caruso. He does a great job having quick reflexes, kind of kneeling down on the ground to get that ball and fling it all the way over.
Yeah, and with how short of an at-bat that was, just the one pitch, they're going to let Jacob Denner face Kevin Keister. Oh, never mind. Tracy Smith is looking to now get the ball. Or pitching coach. Someone's going to meeting at the mound. And this will probably be the end of Jacob Denner's day. What a performance from Jacob Denner this afternoon. 7.2 innings, 3 hits, 1 run, 2 walks, 6 strikeouts, and 99 pitches. Excellent performance by Jacob Denner as he gets a well-deserved round of applause here for his efforts today. One of his best starts in quite a long time.
Yeah, definitely one of the longest outings.
Return to form for one of Michigan's leaders on this team.
Yeah, one of the longest outings that he's had in his career. Really does a great job of preserving this lead. Only allowed that one home run and only 3 hits on the day, so really never too much of a worry for these Michigan fans here in Ann Arbor. But Jacob Denner does a really, really good job there preserving that lead. Still 12-1 here as a new pitcher will warm up. 2 outs for the Wolverines in the top of the 8th. As we get ready, this new pitcher looks like it'll be Ricky Kidd.
Yeah, and Kidd is junior college guy. He's really struggled in his recent starts, so an opportunity for Kidd to have, you know, kind of 4 outs coming into this game with a pretty high ERA. sort of that midweek starter, 5.85 ERA and 20 innings pitched on the year, you know, has had his struggles at times. Was at Henry Ford Community College, I believe, and now is making the JUCO transfer to Michigan.
Yeah, and Ricky Kidd has 9 appearances on the year with 2 starts. Comes in for relief today for Denner. But he'll get a little bit of a warm-up here as Michigan is sitting pretty comfortably with 2 outs now with Keister up to bat for Maryland. He has been the most successful batter, though. Aside from Russell, who hit that home run, he has the highest hitting today with going 2 for 3. He has 2 singles in the first and third. However, a fly out back in the sixth kind of ruined his perfect outing of the day. But nonetheless, he'll be up to bat here.
Yeah, an opportunity for him to get some meaningful outings in a series and try to find his form with plenty of cushion.
So Ricky Kidd on the season has 10 strikeouts, 15 walks, and 7 home runs. Those 7 home runs, again, come in those 9 appearances. So nearly averages a home run a game, but with just a little bit over an inning for him to play today, doubt we'll see another one. As Keister gets ready to go again, 2 for 3 on the day. No runners on with 2 outs for Maryland. As Michigan looks
top
to
of Maryland's
side.
Order, other than Keister has really struggled. Keister 2 for 3, 2 base hits, but Martin's really struggled. Kopian, Hosnar really struggled at the top of this order. And shutting down those power hitters on a good Maryland team has been what's very key. Is a swing and a miss there to even the count up at 1.
Yeah, Martin and Kopian have both been 2 of the stronger batters for Maryland so far this year. Both are 0 for 3 and 0 for 2 respectively, so Denner did a great job of holding them at bay.
The 1-1 pitch is a swing and a miss there.
So that's 2 straight swing and a miss for Keister, as now falls a little bit behind in the count 1-2.
Yeah, Keister down the count 1-2 with a chance to finish off this 8th inning, Ricky Kidd. And that is a swing and a miss, and that'll end the top of the 8th inning.
Ricky Kidd does a great job there of holding on to what Jacob Denner started. Only 4 pitches in that inning.
Yeah, very solid. Just, you know, facing one of Maryland's best hitters and a hot hitter today. 4 pitches, boom, end of the inning. Michigan now heads into the middle of the 8th inning. Due up are the 5, 6, and 7 who have really been kind of the strength of this team. Stanton, Caruso to Rodgers, unless there are any substitutions. We will have to wait and see what Tracy Smith decides. We'll see if Dylan Stan will be indeed heading up to the plate for his at-bat. 3 for 4 on the day, Dylan Stan. And that one play where he didn't get a hit, he got on base with it thanks to an error. So he's been on base in all at-bats today and drew a walk as well. Stan will be coming out, start this half inning, bottom of the 8th for the top of the 9th. Putting the finishing touches on Michigan's effort today. So we will have a pitching change here for Maryland. It will be
Duke McCameron, number 42 for the Terrapins.
Yeah, and Duke McCameron, the right-handed freshman. So Maryland getting a lot of freshmen from Ventnor, New Jersey. So Ocean City, New Jersey, on the Jersey Shore, now making a star here for Maryland. Coming in today with just 4 innings of experience, 4.5 ERA.
So looking to potentially with only 1 inning of play, assuming that Michigan can hold Maryland to under 11 runs in the top of the 9th. If not, could be more if Michigan's able to get some more runs on the board here. Michigan's still holding on to that 12-1 lead. Duke McCameron could have 1 good inning here of experience. Again, like you said, Josh, only 4
yeah,
on the
exactly.
season.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, this Michigan is, unless, you know, the world flips on its axis, they're gonna you know, come away with this game, or barring just an, you know, historic collapse. So it's really just about getting some of those guys that haven't had experience.
So Wilby Stanton up to bat.
Stan And then on deck will be Caruso. So no hitting substitutions for Michigan as of right now. Maybe they might make some changes in the field for the ninth. We do have a lot of defensive substitutions for the Terps to keep track of. Ianaz at second base. DiCanati at first. So some more substitutions as Maryland tries to get some guys into the game as the first pitch of that at-bat goes for a ball. Duke McCarron. Here's the 1-0 pitch from McCarron, and that'll be lifted into shallow center field. Going to be a tough play to make. And a nice diving play there made by Ianaz there, who is the defensive substitution for Maryland. Makes the play out in shallow right center.
He backtracked quite away for that ball, but able to come up with the out there as he kind of falls over.
Absolutely.
Securing it. And oddly, that'll be Stanton's first time that he hasn't made onto a base so far today, as the error put him on in the sixth was the only time he technically didn't get a hit to his name.
First pitch of the at-bat coming in to Cole Caruso is ball. Ball one.
Caruso 3-for-3 on the day. 3 doubles, as we mentioned, just in the sixth inning. Had his 3rd double of the game.
Yeah, looking for his 4th double here. would be pretty cool to have 4 doubles in a game. Sure, that's what he's looking to get. And that goes in there for a strike.
Cole Caruso really elevated his average. Came into the game 202, now 225.
Yeah, that's what a 3-for-3 game or 3-for-4, you know, 3-for-3 game with the walk will do for you.
Yeah.
That pitch goes down for a ball. Counts down 2-1. Righty-righty matchup here as Caruso belts this into left field for a base hit. Looks to make the turn to go to second for his 4th double, but does not get there. But still a base hit. It's a 4-for-4 day for Cole Caruso. And a much important and much needed return to form.
And as great as that hit was, I'm sure he was looking potentially for a
I'm sure he was
a double there.
Trying to find any way to reasonably get sent to second, but
yep.
It was just not in the cards there. Right to Maryland left fielder Jordan Crossland, as now up to the plate is Will Rogers. First pitch in there for strike one. Oh, we have a pinch hitter, actually, instead of Rogers. The pinch hitter Rogers is Junsung Park from Seoul, South Korea. So instead of Rogers, we will have the pinch hitter. So Tracy is starting to empty his bench, give some other guys some more opportunities. So Park with some opportunities here, batting 333 on the year. And just 3 at-bats, so this is 4th at-bat on the season.
And Park got the start back in the midweek game against Michigan State. Had a pretty good day there. Was able to get a base hit. A double in that game, so looking to potentially add to what he's been able to do in the past couple of games where he's gotten a little bit more experience here for the Wolverines.
It's IMG Academy. That pitch is in there for a strike. I thought that was a little outside, but Park didn't like the call. I personally didn't either, but you know that's what the umpire says. Now 12-1 ball game, 1-2, one out to Park. And that ball is hit foul down the third baseline. Diving attempt there by Ricarlo, but does not stay fair.
So Michigan still holding that 12-1 lead with a runner on first base for the Wolverines and one out in the bottom of the eighth inning.
The 1-2 coming in from Duke McCarron is in there, and that is inside for ball two.
Nearly hit Park on that one, but able to stay out of the way a little bit is now. It'll lean its way a little bit more towards the batter's count. Still 2 strikes here for Park, so still has a little bit of room to make up for, but standing at one out.
The 2-2 coming into Park is low for ball three.
And I am glad that Tracy Smith has decided to put in a couple pinch hitters here for the Wolverines.
Yeah,
get some other players' experience. Yep.
With an 11-run lead.
Yep.
Might as well. I would expect Kidd to go out there for the ninth. But we shall wait and see. Here's the full count pitch. Swing and a miss. Out number 2 has been recorded. Karen gets his second out of the inning. It's always interesting when some of these players early in the season just don't have as many innings pitched, how their ERA fluctuates with every strikeout or run given up.
And so Park on the season now in those four at-bats has three strikeouts and one hit. So
and his hit was an RBI as well. Looks like it will be...
will be Tim Brooks still up, yeah.
That first pitch is in there for a strike.
Timbrook 1-for-3 on the day today, 231 average. Bumped ever so slightly from 227 entering the day.
Yep, here's the 0-1 in Timbrook, and that is a little inside there and low for ball one.
So Timbrook started the day, had that sacrifice bunt, and then had a bunt, another bunt in the fourth that was ultimately like ground out, but a single back in the sixth. Got his first hit of the day today.
1-1 coming in to Timbrook, and that is low for a ball. 2-1.
Now the Wolverines have two outs, still a runner on first, so leaning a little bit more towards not being able to add to the scoring here. Still 12-1.
The 2-1 pitch to Timbrook is grounded towards Yanez at second base, is just going to toss it to DeCandy at first to get the out as we head into the top of the ninth.
And again, pretty routine there play. Routine play there. She goes straight to second baseman over to first, and Michigan will be retired. Had no runs in the last two innings that they've had, but two runs down in the bottom of the sixth, two runs in the bottom of the fourth, and then, again, that huge inning in the bottom of the second where they had eight runs has been all the points scored for Michigan, and Maryland still just that lone home run sitting all the way back in the fifth inning. So Michigan looking to preserve one final half inning here.
Looks like it will be Ricky Kidd back out on the mound.
Yeah, so Ricky Kidd hoping to save.
Yeah, Dick Candido will be leading off, freshman Yanazo second, and then Carlo coming in. DeCandido and Azo yet to record a hit. Candido, this will be only his second at-bat of the season and of his college career. He's a freshman.
So again, two-sided thing. While Maryland is down by 11 runs here, they do get to give some of these two freshmen that don't have a lot of experience, they get to give them
You get to get real at-bats against real pitchers in Big Ten play. I mean, what more can you ask for?
Yeah, so we'll go into three of the Maryland substitutions, as you said, Josh, in the top of the sitting at 3-4-5. So now, Riley, we up to bat.
Out of Virginia Beach, Virginia, as the train rolls on by here, honking its horn as the pitch delivered from Kidd is outside for ball number one.
Ricky Kidd again. So far, pretty strong day for him. I mean, he's only had one at-bat, and that one at-bat was a strikeout. So far, so good for him.
Here's the 1-0 from Kidd, and that is very similar spot outside for ball number two. Yeah, this is actually Candido's third at bat. He drew a walk as I mean, it's 500 or that OPS. One at bat, struck out, no walks. But no hits on the season. 3-0 count. That ball, he got the green light on, and that'll be fouled out of play. Not too far from the Michigan locker room.
Yeah, so some good contact there in the 3-0. It was pretty safe to just kind of get the green light, try and get a hit there. Might as well.
You're here for experience. You're not here to, you know, he's not in this game to draw a walk. He's here to try to get a hit. Here's a 3-1, and that is high for ball number four.
So, well, maybe not aiming for that walk. That's what he'll end up with. So, no outs here in the top of the ninth as he'll head over to first base and now up to the bat. Ayanazo.
Ozana coming up to the plate. Out of the freshman out of Southport, Connecticut. Fairfield College Prep.
Nazo has just one at-bat so far this season as a freshman, so just entering his second one.
An RBI, and that ball is grounded for what will be a base hit. Mitch Voigt will toss it to Kyle Durnetti, and that will be runners on first and second with no outs. So Maryland with a chance to score runs, trim the deficit a little bit. If you're Ricky Kidd here on the mound, you're trying to piece things together. This is not kind of the start to the inning that you want by any means. It's Randy Carlo steps at the bat, and you're not facing Maryland's top hitters either. So we'll see what kind of changes make further down. But here's an opportunity for Carlo to get an RBI here.
Carlo has 7 at-bats so far this season with 2 hits. So entering his 8th at-bat, he sits right around a .286 average as a right-handed batter.
The 1-0 from Carlo is popped high in the air. Looks like Dylan Stan is going to make this play, and does. And that will be out of 1. It would have been infield fly regardless.
Pretty good play there. Very, very high hit ball, but Dylan Stanton able to track it. Get the much-needed first out of the inning. Runners still at first and second for the Terrapins, but they will elect to bring in a pinch hitter.
Ben Nardi at it.
Ben Nardi.
Out of Churchill High School in from Potomac, Maryland. Local DMV kid. Ben Nardi now up to bat for the Terps. This kid looks one out already down the hatchet. Already DHing, batting .222 on the year. 2 hits and 9 at-bats with 1 RBI. That first pitch goes in there for a strike.
So decent year for him so far, getting those 2 hits. Looking to add a third here as his team is down 12-1.
The 0-1 is just outside for ball number 1.
Yeah, now sitting at the top of the ninth here, Michigan with a very lofty lead. Looking to end the game here is Ricky Kidd, so far doing a pretty good job of preserving this lead.
Yeah, it's going to be an intense rubber match tomorrow for the series win. The strike there, strike 2. Previewing tomorrow, it's Michigan can get a series win over Maryland. That would be massive for their confidence. That would be 2 series wins in Big Ten play. I'm sure after today's performance, they're sort of ruining a little bit the performance on Friday and kind of blowing that late lead in the 9th. But this win today has to make you feel good and move and get towards, you know, that opportunity to play in Game 3 for a series win against a very good team that will probably be in the tournament this year.
That's so already
2-2 count here for Kidd. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. Out number 2, and Michigan's 1 out away from officially sealing this win and officially evening the series against the Terps.
Yeah, Ricky Kidd, again, doing a good job of keeping these Maryland bats relatively at bay with only that 1 hit that he had. Had the walk to start the inning, got a little out of his groove, but then last 2 at-bats have been out. It's a fly out and that strikeout, so really building his confidence with his second strikeout of the game.
Trying to cross it now in the game. Forced out in his first at-bat, did not get on base. Now up Maryland's last licks as that first pitch went in there for a strike. The 0-1 from Kidd is in there for strike number 2. He's really settled down, you know.
He really has, yeah.
Just evaluating his performance in a kind of a vacuum. 2 base runners, didn't panic, got the fly out, got the strikeout. And now is 1 strike away from sealing this game. Kidd checks the runner on second. Fires in. That'll be a ball grounded to Caruso at third. He's going to throw it to first and officially end the game as Stanton makes the catch. Crossing grounds out to end the game as Michigan takes a dominant 12-1 win here at Ray Fisher Stadium this afternoon.
That was a much, much needed win for Michigan after kind of blowing that lead yesterday. Could not have been...
Couldn't have asked
a very
for a
good
response.
Ending, but yeah, great response here as they very easily win this game 12-1 with those 8 runs scored in the bottom of the second inning. That really just set the tone for the remainder of the game. If they had two hits in that fourth inning and that sixth inning to kind of help add a little bit of cushion to that eight run lead, but there's never really a doubt after that that sixth inning when they got those last two runs that would kind of be it for them, and now we have to 10 wins on the season.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for tuning in today to WCBN FM. My name is Joshua Brown with my partner, Zach Elwood. Thank you so much for tuning in. Enjoy the rest of your day, and we'll leave you with a good, have a great afternoon, and go Blue.